quite quickly, the corner of Melrose and Hawkins in Iowa City, Iowa, and Floyd right there, written on everyone's collective chest, the object of both teams' collective affection. Today at home, the Hawkeyes have been unrelenting all season. We'll see if it holds up today against the resolve of the Golden Gophers. ESPN College Football presents a pivotal Big Ten clash between number 17 Minnesota and number 20 Iowa. Take a look at the standings in the Big Ten up to the moment. A key game today in Columbus between Ohio State and Purdue. Minnesota, meanwhile, is 5-2 in conference play. Iowa even up at 3-3. And Minnesota about to reach new heights under the Glenn Mason era.
Well, Mark, today is Minnesota's last Big Ten game of the year, and they have a chance to finish by making a strong statement. With a win today, they will have their first 10-win season since 1905 and put themselves in a legitimate position for a January bowl game. They have one of the most prolific rushing offenses in the country and have broken just about every Minnesota team offensive record. For Iowa, the senior class has been part of a remarkable turnaround in Iowa football success. Last year, they were Big Ten co-champs. This year, they have a chance to follow up with a 9-win season. Iowa's won 11 straight in Kinnick Stadium, Mark. And for these seniors, it's critical they go out of here with a win in their last game.
Bob, one of those seniors right there, Fred Russell, the diminutive dynamo from just outside of Detroit, Inkster, Michigan, now in the new role of kick returner. Standing poised and ready at his own 5-yard line. And we are underway, the Gophers kicking off to the Hawkeyes. It's going to be Russell at the goal line. Russell found the seam. And Fred Russell with a great return out to the 46th line. And that is where Nathan Chandler will start the offense for the Iowa Hawkeyes. The 6'7" quarterback is the tallest quarterback in all of Division I football, included. He has a brother, Scott Chandler, a freshman on the team. And the two of them would love nothing better than to hook up on a couple of big plays today. Let's take a look at the Best Buy backs and receivers. One of the keys for Iowa offensively, Bob, Mo Brown back in the lineup.
No question, but how about Freddie Russell, Mark? Told us yesterday he was excited about having a chance to return a kickoff. Almost took it to the house.
Great field position at the 46. Chandler on the bootleg. Wide open has Ochoa. Ramon Ochoa down to the 13-yard line. He got in behind Dozier on the play.
Last week against Purdue, Iowa had several opportunities on play action, but they left the plays on the field and could not convert. Here's Nathan Chandler, hits Raymond Ochoa, first play of the game against play action, beats Yuki Dozier the corner, but critical for Iowa to convert those big plays, Mark. Last week we had against Purdue, they failed to convert.
Missed a couple of wide open receivers a couple of times. Not that time, though. First down and 10, number 13 out of the I formation. We'll see that a lot today. Russell dragged down to the 12-yard line by Bill Reed. Let's take a look at the offensive line for Iowa. Gallery, the All-American at left tackle, one of 24 seniors who helped rebuild this program.
And 41 straight starts for Robert Gallery. Contrast right next to him, Mike Jones, a true freshman.
Going up against this defensive front, they'll feed one of the leaders up front for Minnesota. Second down from the 12-yard line. Just underway here, the opening drive of the ball game for Iowa. Chandler out of the backfield to Russell. And good short tackling that time by number 58, Terrence Campbell, one of three talented linebackers. He's joined by Kyle McKenzie and Ben West.
Ben West, a former walk-on, but you see the athleticism of Terrence Campbell. They call him the stick, Martin. He may not weigh 200 pounds.
Meanwhile, in the secondary, a true freshman on the corner in Banks and two seasoned seniors at the safety, Bob.
Two fifth-year seniors, Mark. Both of them will hit you.
Third down and about eight to go. This is usually Mo Brown territory. Chandler sacked back at the 13-yard line. And they're going to say that he was brought down. No fumble. Campbell, a.k.a. Stick, in on another stick. And it's fourth down for Iowa.
Iowa has struggled on third downs this year, Mark. Only at 39%. A big reason they missed Brad Banks from last year, who created plays.
Now we get a look at Nate Kaeding, 11
of 12 on the season, one of the top kickers in the nation, a Lou Groza candidate, had his first miss of the season last week. A game against Purdue in West Lafayette. This one coming from 27 yards out. And Kaeding, one of 24 seniors, playing his final home game. A man who was downright emotional before the game. Kicks it through when we come back. Saad Abdul-Khalik will lead Minnesota onto the field on offense. We'll be back.
My girlfriend bought this furniture.
Uh-huh.
Except there's no instructions.
No instructions. Not bad, huh?
Another Levant Blue?
Fear me. Nice.
Look up, see blue. Levant Blue.
Hey, honey.
Look! That's great. But where's the bookcase that I bought?
What?
GPS MP3.
Hi. Any trouble finding it?
No, not at all.
Iowa Hawkeyes off to a very propitious beginning here. 3-0. Just underway. Look at the scoring drive. 5 plays, 44 yards. The big play was that 42-yard reception from Chandler to Ramon Ochoa. Kaeding to kick off for the Hawkeyes. Back deep. Marion Barber the third. Joined by Lawrence Maroney right there, number 22, and explodes a true freshman out of St. Louis. They kick it the other way. That's going to be Barber the third. Beyond the 30 to the 32-yard line. Mark Jones along with Bob Davey and Holly Rowe down in the field. Bob, last week we saw Iowa miss some big opportunities. Off to a very good beginning this time on offense.
Mark, you're right. I mean, Iowa's not a real explosive football team, but they solved that problem a little bit by putting number one, Freddie Russell, back there returning kicks. But number two, taking advantage of an open receiver, Nathan Chandler hitting Ramon Ochoa. Last week against Purdue, they failed those opportunities, but they need more than field goals because this is a prolific offense here with Minnesota.
The fifth best offense in total yardage in the entire country, and a punishing offense too. Look at this run by Marion Barber the third. Hits the first down out beyond the 40. Saad Abdul-Khalik, meanwhile, is the starting quarterback. A 6-1 team, you know, we've seen him grow up through and into the Minnesota program. Today, though, playing with an injured, non-throwing shoulder. Married with a son, Saif, who's about 6 months old. Now look at our best five starting lineup. Barber with the run a few moments ago.
And Marion Barber making a statement, Mark, on that first run.
Here he is again, taking it to the right side. Patiently waiting for his block to evolve. And another nice run down to the 42. Marion Barber, who a couple of years ago ran for over 1,000 yards behind this offensive line today.
Mark, if you lead the country in rushing offense like Minnesota does, and you don't really run the option a lot, that means you have a great offensive line. And his center, Greg Esslinger, you're now a big fan of offensive centers after watching him yesterday in film.
Great athleticism up front. Hawkeyes get Klaus back, and they whistle this one dead.
There's a penalty marker.
Klaus, number 90.
Another one of those Hawkeye seniors playing his final home game here at Kinnick Stadium.
Oh, it's a snap. Oh, start. Offense. 5 yard carry from the previous side. Go first down.
Glenn Mason in his seventh year as the head man. He's taken the Gophers to bowl games in three of the last four seasons and playing for a New Year's Day bowl still today. Kirk Ferentz, meanwhile, the architect of one of the greatest turnarounds in all of college football over the last 5 years. Just think, his first season, they go 1-10. And last year, 8-2. With four short seasons, he's turned it around. Play fake. Going up top. Ellison falls down. No flags on the play. Defended well by Bob Sanders. Let's take a look at the linebackers for the Hawkeyes. Chad Greenway and Abdul Hodge, number one and number two in the Big Ten, in tackle.
And Norm Parker loved both these young inside linebackers. In this secondary, Bob Sanders, number 33, Mark. Not only a great defensive player, but a great special teams player as well.
Reset drop by Abdul Khalid, fires high, complete to Ellison at the 37-yard line. And Holly Rowe, what are we playing for today?
Well, guys, you get the sense that they're playing for a lot. There's a lot of atmosphere, a lot of juice down. This is a rivalry game. Minnesota and Iowa are bordering states. Back in 1935, the governor started playing for a full-blooded championship pig called Floyd of Rosedale. It was a life event, now it's a trophy. They took it to practice all week this week to motivate the Hawkeyes. But Minnesota played for the last week. The coaches said they had a great week of practice, and they're up as well.
All right, Holly, a bowl game-type atmosphere here today. Incomplete. Intended once again for Ellison. Going to be fourth down for Minnesota.
Minnesota loves the three-step quick passing game. That time Assad Abdul Khalid throws it a little bit high. Jared Ellison, Minnesota now in a decision situation right here, Mark.
Keith Lloyd, their place kicker, has a very strong leg with a career long of 54 yards. This one is going to come from about 54 yards. He made a game-winning kick last week in the trophy game against Wisconsin. Low snap, they get it down, and it's just a little short. Reese, what a start. Let's go back to you in the studio.
Indeed, it is. Mark Trev Albert, Mark May with me, and guys, some other action going on in the Big Ten right now. Wisconsin trying to get over that post-Ohio State slide, off three in a row, taking on Michigan State and Jim Sorge, finding Lee Evans in the end zone, and Wisconsin grabbed a 7-0 lead on the Spartans early in the first.
Jim Sorge, an amazing story, Mark. We watched him on the tape against Minnesota last week. Coming back from that injury, continues to play well.
Good point, Bob. First down and 10. Two tight ends, two wide receivers, Fred Russell. Dancing behind that offensive line and brought to the 38-yard line by Justin Fraley. Fred Russell coming into this ballgame has carried the ball 235 times. And considering the fact that he's 5'8", 190 pounds, that's a pretty durable little guy, Bob.
Yeah, Mark, and the next running back behind him has 26 carries. So you look at 237 carries to 26. This is a durable guy. And if you look at the size difference right there, it's remarkable.
Second down and 9, Ochoa in motion. A draw play to Fred Russell. Couldn't get to the edge. Great tackle by Terrence Campbell. Dick has been sticking the Hawkeyes in their tracks so far in the early going.
You talk about defending Fred Russell at 5'7". All of a sudden, he darts out of there. This week in practice, Greg Hudson, the defensive coordinator for Minnesota, Mark, on the cards that he drew up the play for the scout team, he just told the running back to go ahead and run wherever you want because Fred Russell's kind of like the air coming out of the balloon. He just goes anywhere on that football field.
And Bob, look at that stat. A big difference in third down conversion numbers between last year and this year for Iowa. Third down and long, 9 to go. Chandler for Brown, and it's picked off. Eli Ward. Down to the 22-yard line, the Gophers with the first turnover of the ball game.
Mark, you mentioned Iowa has struggled on third down. What Minnesota does is play man under with a safety screen, and Eli Ward is going to break on the ball and kick off the pass. But it's man under coverage. They drop the safety down into the hole as the robber. Excellent scheme right there by Greg Hudson. Talked him into running the crossing route, but Eli Ward knocked down as the robber and took it away.
First down and 10, back side of the eye. That was their 10th interception on the season. Maroney, the freshman, stopped up at about the 20-yard line by Bob Sanders. Bob Sanders, number 33 for Iowa in the black and gold. Norm Parker, defensive coordinator, says he is the hardest hitter he's seen in his 30-something years in all of football.
And Norm has seen a few guys, Mark. This is a great matchup. Minnesota, number one in scoring offense in the Big Ten, 41 points a game. Iowa, number one scoring defense, 15 points a game.
Talked about the prowess of Minnesota running the ball, over 304 yards per contest on the ground. Tops in the nation. They run it between the tackles. Maroney out of St. Louis, brought down by Howard Hodges, the defensive end. And look at these impressive statistics. Iowa with the number 5 rush defense in the country.
Mark, maybe the most impressive statistic isn't on that chart. Minnesota ran the ball for 424 yards on Michigan. That's the most rushing yardage Michigan has ever given up in a football game, and Minnesota lost the game. But that's unbelievable.
Looking at 3rd down and 5 for the Gophers. Khalif incomplete and almost intercepted. Batted away nicely that time by Abdul Hodge out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida. It was intended for Matt State, the tight end.
Abdul Hodge, the number 2 tackler in the Big Ten, shows he can break on the ball right there. Undercut face to tight end. Great sudden change stop by Iowa's defense. Forces the field goal attempt by Reese Lloyd.
Here's the young man from Dover, England. Just got that one inside the right upright from 33 yards out. And we are knotted at 3 apiece. This time they convert on the field goal, and Iowa will have the ball when we come back to Kinnick Stadium right after this.
Foot, leg.
Yeah, you know, you can only get that DVD here. Get you front and center for the Rolling Stones show.
Get 4 Flicks, the ultimate live Rolling Stones concert DVD box set, exclusively at Best Buy. Thousands of possibilities. Get yours.
All right, it's between you guys.
Best bartender gets the job.
After you. Oh, boy.
The best loop, please.
I've got this one. Canada's finest.
Look up, see blue, Labatt Blue.
Is it hot in here, or is it just him?
Saturday, brought to you by Labatt Blue, imported from Canada. Look up, be blue. By Hummer, check out the H2 at Hummer.com. Hummer, like nothing else. And by Olympus and Stylus Digital, designed to be small, designed to resist weather, designed to do more.
Iowa City under late fall skies. We are tied at 3 apiece. Back at Kinnick Stadium, I'm Mark Jones along with Bob Davey and Holly Rowe. And Iowa's defense holding both times Minnesota crosses.
over into their side of midfield. Mark, one thing you won't see in the stat, Nathan Chandler made that tackle on Eli Ward to keep it from being a touchdown on the interception.
Here's Fred Russell again, his second kickoff return of the game. First one went for 46 yards. There's a flag down at the 21, and Russell is brought down at the 34. Fred Russell got a little juice out of this crowd early in the ballgame. Russell and the Hawkeyes bound and determined and poised to run the football early and often in this ballgame. Two great matchups in prime time on ESPN and ESPN2 tonight at 7 Eastern on ESPN2. Larry Fitzgerald and number 6, Pitt, take on West Virginia. Fresh off their win over Miami. They visit West Virginia, and at 7:45 on ESPN, number 13, LSU, a must-win for them in the hunt for the Sugar Bowl. Pass is complete to Eric Jensen.
Mark, I'm really impressed with the escapability and athleticism of Nathan Chandler. I mean, this guy's 6'7", 255 pounds. He looks like an offensive lineman, but he's really elusive. I think does a great job with the play action, and a good point for Iowa. He's completing the play actions this week.
Pick up a 13 and a first down. Mel Lewis now. Feet back out of the offset eye. Ramona Choa scooping that one up before it hit the ground at the 49 of Minnesota, about 4 yards short of the first down.
You have to love Ramona Choa. They call him Razor. I guess it's back from childhood. He was a big fan of a pro wrestler. But, Mark, he came into this year in his first 3 years. He had 5 catches in the program. This year, that makes his 24th catch. He's also a punt and a kickoff returner. And it was great to see his parents out there on the field coming from California to be a part of it.
It's a wonderful scene before the game. Here's Chandler now, audibling at the line of scrimmage on 2nd and 3. Mel Lewis chopped down behind the line of scrimmage by Tremaine Banks. The true freshman came in and knifed through that offensive line.
Mark, one way to get the eighth man in the front is by bringing the corner on the corner fire. And that time, Greg Hudson brought the corner from the boundary as the eighth man, and he put a big hit on the running back.
This time, Bob, the Hawkeyes come out with a 4-receiver set on 3rd and 6. Cervantes below him back. Chandler, incomplete, intended for Brown at the 43. And it'll be 4th down. Mo Brown struggled a little bit this year. He's missed several games because of an ankle injury. Still not quite 100%, but he did give them a spark late in the game last week against Purdue.
Mark came back last week, had 8 catches against Purdue for 129 yards. But you're right, he's still not healthy. Yesterday when we met with him, he had that ice pack on. That's just reality. That's what it's going to be through the rest of the season for him, trying to get off back from that ankle.
Bradley punching. Clinton White signals for the fair catch and lets it bounce. Going to take a short break. When we come back, the number one rush offense in the nation on display. And Bob Davies is going to break it down for you in Football 101.
They're saying running back by committee is bad for football. I was just saying I see the relevance of committees, just not for running backs. Dan Patrick just used the word unitard in his column. I was just saying unitard is one of the most underutilized words in the English language. Wait, I was thinking that, and they were thinking that.
Serving you with Hi, John Gretter again with Gretter Motor Company in Kyoto and Gretter Ford in Washington. The 2004 models have arrived at both my family's locations. In Washington, we have the all-new Ford F-150 or the restyled Ford minivan, the Freestar. In Kyoto, check out the restyled Chevy Malibu or the all-new Chevy Colorado pickup. Also, get your first look at Buick's new sport utility, the Rainier. Whether it's a new look or an old favorite, we have you covered. So come down and find out why the deals and service are always better at Gretter's.
It's our Minnesota, college football at noon. Mark Jones and Bob Dare, Holly Rowe bringing it to you. Oh, it's college football on Saturday. It's Big Ten style. You know they're going to make it.
Put the needle in the record and let it play. Maroney brought down at the 10-yard line by Abdul-Hodge.
You didn't realize Iowa City was the birthplace of blues, did you?
It is now.
It is now.
South Dubuque in the pedestrian mall. You talk about Iowa's defense. Last week against Purdue, they played without Jared Clough. They played without Grant Steen, the outside linebacker. They got embarrassed a little bit because Purdue ran the football. They're going to be tested this afternoon again, Mark. A lot of subtleties in that running game. This time they pass to Ellerson, complete, spins away. Out to the 18-yard line, where he's 2 yards short of the first down. Let's go to Reese.
Mark, Taco Bell takes us down to Miami. Syracuse and the Hurricanes. Derek Crude have been there starting for Berlin and having some of the same problems Berlin had. Threw a pick to Rich Stanley, 3-0 Orange after the turnover. Indiana and Penn State. Nittany Lions have lost 6 in a row. Matt LaVecchio to Glenn Johnson. That's just the 4th touchdown pass of the year for the Hoosiers. That would be ugly, guys.
Reached 3rd down and 2. Minnesota going to run it. Maroney with those quick feet gets the first down at the 21-yard line. Lawrence Maroney, the true freshman out of St. Louis, could reach the 1,000-yard mark this afternoon. Marion Barber a little bit nicked up, Mark, coming into this football game. Lawrence Maroney, the true freshman, going to get his opportunity to go over 1,000 yards. Now you see Thomas Tapé in there in the single back set. So Minnesota blessed with a lot of good running backs. Two tight ends in a single back set. Abdul Khalik incomplete and a nice hit by number 20, Antoine Allen. Here's Bob Davey breaking down the subtleties of the running game.
Minnesota leads the country in rushing offense, averaging over 300 yards per game. Their signature play is the outside zone, and they love to pull the tackle in the center. This team is effective for 3 reasons. Number 1, the tight end has a great angle to block down on the defensive end. Number 2, it creates a mismatch with a 300-pound offensive tackle pulling to block a smaller outside linebacker. Number 3, by pulling the center play side, he becomes the fourth blocker and is able to cut off the inside linebacker.
And here they go. They run it to perfection. Tapé, as just diagrammed almost by Bob Davey, out to the 41-yard line. And another first down for the Gophers. Juggernaut offensively.
Mark, we talk about the outside zone. Here you see the tackle pulling around. You see the center coming around. Thomas Tapé. But again, because of the athleticism of the offensive line, they're able to pull and create mismatches with linemen coming around blocking linebackers.
First down and 10 for the Gophers, starting to get untracked a little bit here offensively. Abdul Khalik slides at the 44, and let's go back to more football 101.
Mark, Minnesota also runs out of a two-back set. And if you're going to run the ball with two backs, you got to find a way to block the eighth man. Minnesota does it two ways. First, you see the wide receiver cracking the strong safety. Second, to account for the eighth man, they run the option. They actually option and pitch off the seventh man, the outside linebacker. The fullback arcs and blocks the eighth man, the safety. So Minnesota, Mark, a great plan out of two backs and one back. That's why they average 300 yards a game rushing.
And this time, Bob, they do line up in a two-back set. They give it to Maroney over midfield into Iowa territory at the 48-yard line. Tell you about Lawrence Maroney, a true freshman. Interesting young man out of St. Louis, Missouri. Glenn Mason flew to St. Louis to watch him compete in a track meet during the recruitment period when he was trying to work on him. And he saw him run in his sprint and actually got back to Minneapolis in time for
his daughter's graduation ceremony, but the story had a good ending, Bobby. Got Maroney signed.
Hey, whatever that plane fare cost, it was worth it for Glenn Mason. He's had three straight games, Mark, over 100 yards.
Here's Maroney again, this time running between the tackles down to the 43-yard line. And let's go downstairs to Holly.
Hey, guys, you're getting a healthy dose of Lawrence Maroney right now because Marion Barber III is on the sideline with an unidentified injury. Right now, he's been on the bike. It looks like it may be something with his lower body, his hamstring. Because of new federal legislation, they're not giving us an exact update. But he does look like he will not be playing right now. We'll get you more at halftime.
Marion Barber III, a young man whose father was all-conference at Minnesota, played in the NFL. Recently signed his younger brother, Dominique Barber. He's a very natural runner, I'm told. Maroney stopped behind the line of scrimmage at the 43-yard line by Antoine Allen coming up on corner support.
And Minnesota has as impressive offensive stats as I've ever seen, Mark. Starting right here on third down efficiency, they're number one in the Big Ten, 53% on third down. The fewest turnovers in the Big Ten with 11, the fewest sacks in the Big Ten, all because they can run the football.
53.2%, there it is, on third down, the 10th play of the drive. Quick three-step drop, and they finally complete one to Aaron Hosak. And it's a first down to the 33-yard line. Hosak, an imposing target at 6'5".
They love the quick passing game. They love the slant to big 6'5" Aaron Hosak. Right here, good tackle. Might be a late hit coming in here by Sean Considine, but no flag.
Hosak last week made a huge catch to keep a key drive alive late in the game against Wisconsin. Here's Luke audibling at the line now. 11th play of the drive, it's Maroney. They're going to blow it dead. Under 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Iowa has called a timeout. We're going to call one and get one back to Reese Davis and tell us what's up with Joe Powell, Reese.
All right, Mark, Penn State on that six-game losing streak. One more loss to be the most losses in their 117 years of playing football. Down 7-0 to Indiana. Zach Mills finds Tony Johnson, and Nittany Lions are on the board. They have it evened up about halfway through the first.
All right, Bruce, and here's a look at the Big Ten standings. Bob, I know you talk about if and buts being candies and nuts, that old saying, but Minnesota, I think, really one of the best two-loss teams in the entire nation. By rights, they had Michigan. You talked about them rushing for over 400 yards. In a sense, they self-destructed the subsequent week against Michigan State, but if not for a couple of self-inflicted wounds, Minnesota's looking at a perfect season.
Oh, no question, Mike, Mark, to have the opportunity to win 10 games, that's a heck of a statement. Glenn Mason takes a lot of heat for the schedule. I mean, the reality is, they beat Tulsa, Troy State, Ohio U, Louisiana Lafayette, Northwestern, Indiana, Illinois, Penn State. None of those teams, none of the BCS teams in that group had a winning record, but they did beat Wisconsin last week. I think that was the first BCS team they beat with a winning record. But a great season, 9-2, chance to win 10 games for the first time since 1905. That's a bunch of ball games.
And looking at a chance of playing perhaps in a New Year's Day bowl game. Huge discrepancy right now in the rushing yards. And it's Ellison on the reverse. Brought down behind the line of scrimmage at the 35-yard line by Chad Greenway. Here's a look at one of their two losses. The big one against Michigan at home. They had Michigan down and out. And the Wolverines took home the little brown jug. And then the subsequent week against Michigan State, they put themselves in a hole early. The Antob ran a kickoff back 100 yards. As Michigan State capitalized on three Minnesota fumbles to win 44-38. Back here, second down and 12 for the Gophers. Another quick three-step drop complete, this time to Ellison at the 27-yard line. Jared Ellison, a young man who is out of the doghouse of Glenn Mason, and right now in his very good graces. Had a real great season on the whole.
They call him their most consistent wide receiver. He has 17 carries, Mark. They use them a lot on that wide receiver reverse package.
Pick up a third down and 4 from the 27. Ellison and Hosak, a couple of tall wideouts for the Gophers offense.
incomplete, intended for Hosack that time. Defended by Javon Johnson. And it's fourth down. In comes Reese Lloyd, the place kicker.
Mark, again, a three-step quick slant route. Iowa getting up in their face, playing man-to-man tight coverage, taking that quick game away. This is one of your favorites right here. The namesake of Reese Davis,
Reese Lloyd. He spells it a little differently, but yeah, phonetically, same deal. 14th play, Lloyd into the field goal. And he is through, giving Minnesota a three-point lead. Last week, he was through as well against Wisconsin. After calling a couple of timeouts, Wisconsin tried to ice him. It didn't work. He hit it, and where did he go? Over the Badger bench for the act. He was the first one there, Bob. He hurdled that thing like a world-class hurdler. Man from Dover, England. And let's go to Holly Rowe for more.
Well, guys, Reese Lloyd is from Dover, England, and this is his first year with Minnesota. So you might wonder how he even knows about the rivalry of getting Paul Bunyan's axe. Well, Glenn Mason, in a timeout right before he went to kick that winning field goal, he was giving him advice on the hold, the snap, but what he really was giving him advice on was don't forget to go get the axe. Reese Lloyd listened to his coach, and that was a mad dash.
You talk about these rivalry games. You know, they give, like the pigs are going to give away the bronze pig after this game or the axe last week. Not just the pig, it's Floyd.
Well, I don't mean to hurt Floyd's feelings.
But you know, it's not about the trophy as much as it is that ceremony of running through the other team's face to claim that trophy. And that's one of the things Kirk Ferentz did this week. He showed his football team, Reese Lloyd, running through that Wisconsin team area and getting that axe last week. So that's what it's all about, Mark. Not let somebody come into your stadium and steal Reese out of this thing.
That's the first thing that Fred Russell told us. He didn't want them to come over the bench to take Floyd, nor on the return out to the 30-yard line. As Holly Rowe chronicled, it started off as a bet between a couple of governors of Iowa and Minnesota back in 1935. And interesting, we saw him in the office there. He had an Iowa Hawkeye tattoo on him, Bob. A new addition. I don't think that the trophy started off that way, but he had a little black and gold tattooed on him.
I'll tell you what, you're getting attached to this. I mean, you're talking to him like we saw him yesterday, and it looks like there was some interaction there in that meeting we
had. A little bacon for breakfast. Look how close it was. Here's Chandler, wide open in the flat to Jensen. And Jensen has a first down at the 43-yard line. Let's go back to Reese Davis.
All right, Mark, and back to the Orange Bowl. We're about halfway late in the first quarter. Kellen Winslow came into the game, and Derek Kruger did this press. Now look at Derek Kruger looking left, can't find him, but he goes back to the right, finds Ryan Moore wide open, touchdown Miami. It's been a short coming, and brought the lens, and Kruger able to go to the other side of the field, Kane's up four.
All right, back here, it's first down and 10, under a minute to go in the first quarter. They go up by field goal here. The bootleg again by Chandler has a lot of room. And this tall guy can run a little bit. Oh, and that's a little spin move. He got it on spin cycle and dried out the Gopher defense for another first down.
We talked about his athleticism. Once again, at 6'7", the tallest quarterback in the NCAA, 255 pounds. He's on the loose. That's not your favorite thing to try to tackle this quarterback. Little spin action right there. That's impressive, Mark.
A 17-yard pickup for Nathan Chandler.
Fourth Iowa quarterback in 4 years. Nathan Chandler, a senior, so next year will be their fifth quarterback in 5 years, Mark.
A true freshman right now, waiting in the wings. This is Jamel Lewis, who came back early from knee surgery. Made a somewhat miraculous recovery, and tomorrow morning, don't miss the bet. NFL pregame show in the business, folks. NFL Countdown, presented by Old Spice. Chris Berman and the gang preview all of Sunday's action. It all begins tomorrow at 11 a.m. Eastern time on ESPN. Going to be enjoying that, Bob.
Mark, we talked about Minnesota's impressive offensive statistics. On the flip side, Iowa comes into this game 91st in the country out of 117 in total offense. A lot of injuries, a lot of graduation from last year.
Here's Chandler going for Ochoa, and there's a flag on the play. So Yuki Dozier held him like a grudge that time. I mean, he had a full grab
of Ochoa's uniform with 6 seconds to go in the first quarter. It's going to be first and 10 for Iowa.
Ochoa may not be real fast, but he's quick and he's elusive. Right there, he beats him at the line of scrimmage. Obvious that UT Dozier held him. But Mark, you know what? In college football, that's probably a good decision because it could have been a touchdown.
He's given up six.
But you notice UT Dozier, again, young corner, get enthralled with looking into that backfield at the action and the play action in the quarterback. You have to keep your eyes, Mark, on the wide receiver. Don't be looking in that backfield man-to-man coverage.
Caught Keaton. Good toss to Fred Russell back in the ballgame. Behind Cervantes.
Chandler to pass. And the defense stayed home that time. Terrence Campbell with the pressure. Let's go downstairs to Holly. Holly, what do you have coming up?
Hey, guys, coming up, we will show you how Kirk Barron got his team fired up for this game. He said it's more than playing for big, and we'll show you what he showed his team coming up next.
DSDSHD, call your cable operator or satellite provider today.
Hi.
Hey, guys.
So,
my girlfriend bought this furniture.
Uh-huh.
Except there's no instructions.
Who needs instructions? Not bad, huh?
Another Labatt Blue?
Fear me. Nice.
Look up, see blue. Labatt Blue.
Hey, honey. Look.
That's great. But where's the bookcase that I bought?
What?
Olympus brings you the incredible power of a 10x optical zoom. Get 10 times closer. Now that's a powerful zoom.
Zoom, 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 zoom.
The ultra zoom from Olympus, designed to do more.
Zoom, 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 zoom.
Men don't like to shave. They'd rather light their shorts on fire or eat dirt. Easy, fellas. Nivea soothes the pain of shaving. With moisturizers and vitamins, Nivea for Men Aftershave Bomb soothes and improves. Nivea for Men. More evolved skincare.
In January 1961, we were unsure who we elected. In November 1963, we couldn't assess what we lost. On Sunday, we'll discover what we gained. JFK, a presidency revealed on the History Channel.
At BASF, we don't make the rain gear. We make it drier. We don't make the seat. We make it safer. We don't make the clothes. We make them cleaner. We don't make the bandage. We make it stick better. We don't make a lot of the products you buy. We make a lot of the products you buy better. BASF.
This holiday season, deck your halls and leave them decked. And deck out your kitchen, too. At the Home Depot, we're more than a store. We're where holiday home improvements and decorations last all year. Right now at the Home Depot and Expo Design Center, you'll have no payments, no interest until January 2005 on all flooring and appliance purchases of $299 or more when you use your Home Depot or Expo consumer credit card. And for installation you can trust, let at-home services professionally install it for you. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Back at Kinnick Stadium at the corner of Hawkins and Melrose in Iowa City, Iowa. 4-6-3, the Golden Gophers leading right now by a field goal. Mark Jones along with Bob Davey and Holly Rowe down in the field. Iowa with the ball at Minnesota's 25-yard line. Minnesota playing for its first 10-win season in decades, since 1905. Mark, normally when Cervantes is in here at fullback in a one-back set, it's normally passed. Old Brown, a dangerous receiver in motion. Comes to Ochoa, and he's stuck right away at the 21-yard line by Tremaine Banks, who's made a couple of key plays already in the ballgame. Time now for our gateway game track. This is what's at stake. Floyd of Rosedale. And it is also senior day. Nate Kaeding, the senior place kicker, welling up with emotion in the pregame introductions as they were introduced to the fans with their respective families. Kicking game playing a prominent role so far in this contest. Minnesota with two, Iowa with one. Third down and six. They've yet to convert on third down today. Chandler to pass. And Ochoa hung on to it at the 13-yard line, close to the first down marker. They're going to give it to him. Ramon Ochoa, Mark, on senior day, taking advantage of it. The crossing route against man-to-man coverage. He beats Yuki Dozier inside. We're seeing a matchup develop in this game already. Yuki Dozier, 25 the corner on Ramon Ochoa, number 13, the little wide receiver from Iowa. Haywood, California, first down and 10. Brown split wide to the top of your screen. Chandler comes back the other way. Ochoa makes the catch at the 3-yard line. Again, play action pass. This time Ochoa on Tremaine Banks, the freshman defensive back. A little curl route. He misses the tackle. Nathan Chandler right now, Mark, got some confidence in his passing game.
Chandler 8 of 12 passing for 100 yards.
First down and goal to the Hawkeyes. Fred Russell, the lone back. Play fake. Chandler going to keep it himself. Touchdown, Iowa. But not when he weighs 255 pounds and coming downhill north and south like Nathan Chandler.
Giving Iowa a 9-6 lead. Kaeding with the extra point knocks it through, and the Hawkeyes lead by four. Chandler with his fourth rushing touchdown this season. Lowering his hat down and getting the job done. Back after this.
PlayStation 2.
We didn't just give the new Ford F-150 more horsepower. We gave it the most low-end torque. Why did we push farther than anyone else? So you could do more than anyone else. Only this truck earned the right to be the next F-150. If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
First there was one blade, then two, then three. But four blades? Give me a break, right? Wrong. The new shit Quattro has the power of four blades and two conditioning strips, which makes Quattro unlike any other razor. And those four blades give you an incredibly close, smooth shave. Your 5 o'clock shadow shows up late. Four blades. Where will it stop? Here. Shit Quattro, the power of four.
Iowa leading 10-6, just under 14 minutes to go here in the first half. Hawkeyes to kick off. Clinton White and Lawrence Maroney back deep. Ochoa, a busy receiver on that last scoring drive for the Hawkeyes. Kaeding going to knock this one in the end zone. And out the back of the end zone. Hey, Reese Davis, boy, Wisconsin hasn't been the same since defeating Ohio State.
No, they really haven't, Mark. It's starting to look a little bit like their pre-Ohio State self. Wayne Smith going in against Michigan State, and
Badgers at home up by two touchdowns early in the second quarter, trying to snap that three-game losing streak. Florida and South Carolina inside their own tank. Chris Lee, boys up. The boys are savvy and veteran. That might have been a freshman mistake. George Dawes with the sack for the safety. Gamecocks by a Duke.
All right, and now look once again at the most prolific rushing offense in the country. Maroney trying to get to the edge, broke a couple of tackles. Lawrence Maroney made something out of nothing, got 4 yards when he could have been tackled for a loss of about three.
Signature play for Minnesota, Mark. We go back and take a look again. Really a continuation of football 101. You see the offensive tackle pool, you see the center pool. They're getting big bodies on smaller linebackers, creating mismatches. You see Esslinger 61 come around the horn right here. He loves to chop. He gets more linebackers on the ground than any center I have seen, Mark.
And it's not often you see, as you pointed out earlier when we were watching film, you don't see centers pulling like that in this game. Second and five. Ellison had it knocked away. Nice play on the corner by Javon Johnson. And let's go downstairs to Holly. How'd they get fired up, Ms. Rowe?
Hey, guys. Well, when Chris Ferris came here as an assistant coach in the 1980s, he said, frankly, I thought it was a little silly that we were playing for a big trophy. But he said the first time that Minnesota won and came over and snapped that, he got it. Possession is the key. So this week, he showed his team the 1998 video when Minnesota stormed the field and took back Floyd of Rosedale. He says there's nothing like having somebody come over your bench and snap something away. Got his team fired up for today.
It almost feels violated when you see that happen. Abdul Khalik, nothing but real estate ahead of him, and he slides in for the first down at the 37-yard line. This year he's been much healthier, and as a result, he's made himself that much more lethal offensively, Bob.
And it reminds you of Iowa last year with Brad Banks. That's why Minnesota is number one in the Big Ten in third down efficiency, Mark, because they look for the quick pass. If you play man-to-man coverage and run with the receivers, Assad Abdul-Khalik will tuck it and run for the first down.
Right now, the unquestioned leader of that offense. First down and 10, Thomas Tepe in a tailback. Takes the toss into the boundary. Tepe upended at the 37-yard line by Howard Hodges. And for more on the quarterback, Khalik, let's go to Holly.
Well, Coach Davey, you talk about him having a Brad Banks kind of year. Well, Assad Abdul-Khalik has been maligned much of his career at Minnesota, very critiqued by the fans because he didn't always win the big games. Offensive coordinator Tony Peterson sat him down this year and said, look, you can go out like Brad Banks did at Iowa. You can have that kind of senior season that he had. They looked at some of the film, saw how much Brad Banks runs, and he has used that as a motivation. In fact, several of the Iowa coaches told us yesterday, they look like we did last year with Assad Abdul-Khalik as our Brad Banks.
Abdul-Khalik really has become the leader of this ball team, and in many ways, in what we in the media refer to as an automatic or good quote, he's the guy that a lot of the local media there run to when they want some interesting and neutral perspective on certain issues affecting the football team.
You're right, Mark, and we see right there that Derek Robinson, number 98, the defensive tackle, is down for Iowa.
We're going to take a short break and hopefully get a little bit more on that injury report when we come back.
A truck like this isn't built in a factory. It's built in the farm, fields, concrete streets, and construction sites that map the landscape of an entire country. Because when Ford builds the new F-150, there are promises to keep. And only one truck earned the right to be the next F-150. If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
It's not that my kids aren't adorable. I just need some space to get some work done. I need one of those computers that'll...
I know what you mean.
come check this out.
Gateway presents the I Want a Computer That'll Go Where My Kids Can't notebook sale. Get $200 off the full-featured M305X complete with CD burner DVD combo drive. Or get $100 off when you upgrade to the XL with the mobile Intel Pentium 4 processor M. Three ways to Gateway for two great notebooks that make it easy to work anywhere.
Robinson of Iowa shaken up a few moments ago before we went to break. 13-12 to go in the first half. I'm Mark Jones along with Bob Davey and Holly Rowe down in the field. Minnesota looking for its first 10-win season since 1905. Iowa, meanwhile, is 7-3. Looking at competing in a big bowl game as well with a win here today. Their last home game on Senior Day. Maroney. Breaking tackles out into Iowa territory at the 49-yard line. Naz Greenway finally bringing down the true freshman, Lawrence Maroney. A pickup of 14 yards. This time Minnesota out of I-backs, Mark. Run a little counter, weak. Right there you see Chad Greenway. You knock on the arm tackle, Lawrence Maroney. This is an impressive young back. Len Mason told us early in the year this kid has it all, Mark. First down and 10. Play fake. Ellison complete at the 37-yard line. And let's go back to Reese Davis.
All right, Mark, let's check in down in the SEC. Tennessee fresh off that win over Miami against Mississippi State, which has pretty much been halfway. Casey Clawson, Chris Cannon, the Big Orange on top of the Bulldogs, 7-0 in the first quarter.
Their first down and 10.
You see how impressive Minnesota is offensively. They're throwing the play action, the come route, back route on first and 10. This is an efficient offense.
Here's the pay. Brought down behind the line of scrimmage at the 39. Tyler Lucci. Take a look at this record-setting offense for the Minnesota Gophers. Setting team highs in several categories this year, averaging over 40 points per game.
Mark, they've had six games this year of over 500 yards on offense. They've had 10 30-point games.
I think arguably one of the best two-loss teams in the nation.
And they love this bunch formation right here, bunching the receivers up tight.
On second and 13, Maroney not finding much space between the tackles. Brought down to the 38, and as Holly Rowe reported a few moments ago in the first quarter, Marion Barber III seems to be shaken up. He was riding the bike on the sideline, so it's been a steady diet of Maroney. There's a look at Barber, who has rushed for over 1,000 yards this year, 1,134 coming into this contest.
And they're going against a great rush defense. Iowa fifth in the country, Mark, in rushing defense. Held seven of the last 18 under 75 yards rushing.
On third and 12, Abdul Khalik. Post out. Complete near the 10-yard line. He got in behind Javon Johnson, and Hosack has about 8 inches in height on him. A 26-yard pickup.
Mark, you said it. 6 foot five, 5 foot nine. Throws the fade. That is a great, great throw.
I think it's out over the quick. I think that left shoulder.
I think it's fine.
It's okay. On first down and 10, nose of the ball resting at the 12. Maroney is the lone back at two tight end formation. And blitz and brought down, and a fumble. Hawkeyes recover the ball. Matt Ross recovered the loose ball.
Tyler Lucci, number 60, came into the game when Derek Robinson was injured. Minnesota forgot to block him. They just turned him loose, and Matt Ross comes up with the recovery. But right there, Mark, that is not an error characteristic of Minnesota. They just flat turned Lucci loose.
For an offensive line that is always in sync, they blew it on that one. First down and 10. Fred Russell on the play fake, and Chandler sacked back at the 10-yard line by six. Terrence Campbell already with four tackles in the ballgame, a couple of them for loss.
Mark,
these offenses normally do not give up negative plays. Right here, you're going to see the stick nice through there and make the play on Nathan Chandler.
Bob, the coaches say that they got to get him to eat at least six times a day. They're trying to get about 3,500 calories in him per day. That's a lot.
I'll send you through that. Glenn Mason ought to give you a call and find out how you do it, because you got that art down to a science.
Second and 20. Russell. Hey, Reese, we got an upset brewing back there.
Still, Mark, going for the South Carolina sweep of the state of Florida, including Miami. South Carolina over Florida after punting to Florida State last week. Corey Boyd going in. The Gamecocks on top, 9-0. And speaking of the Hurricanes against Syracuse, with this Walter Reyes touchdown, the Orange has now scored more points today against Miami than they have in the previous three games, and they're up by three.
Mark, we're seeing a lot of man-to-man coverage underneath. Look for crossing right here out of Iowa. They decide to run the ball.
One of the few times they do that, Cervantes. Got to throw the dog a bone once in a while. Eli Ward hitting him out of bounds about 3 yards shy of the first down. We're here at Kinnick Stadium, where the Iowa Hawkeyes have won 11 consecutive games in Iowa City, Iowa. I'm Mark Jones, along with Bob Davies and Holly Rowe, a couple of teams playing for Floyd of Rosedale, a trophy that was initiated back in 1935. That is Quentin White from Minnesota, setting at his own 32. Bradley into punt for Iowa, standing at his own 18. A low line drive spiral. White fumbles it. And Banks recovers it. And he's drilled back at the 27. Minnesota having a hard time hanging on to the ball today. We're going to take a short break, and when we come back, we'll look inside and analyze the Big Ten. Take a big picture view in just a moment.
NFL's home stretch begins. Get set for Week 11.
That's what we're here for.
Countdown's got the Parcells and Belichick reunion covered. We'll talk to the tuna about the turnaround and Big D.
He knows everything there is to know about football.
And preview the primetime showdown between the division leaders, Cowboys and Patriots. Plus up-to-the-minute game report from around the league. Sunday NFL Countdown, presented by Old Spice at 11 a.m. Then later at 8:30, it's the Cowboys versus the Patriots on Sunday Night Football.
The new home is the single largest investment a family will make. Hi, this is Ed Kincaid. Since 1986, over 1,500 families have entrusted Century Homes for their new home. At Century Homes, we have a great lineup of new manufactured and modular homes on display. And with interest rates at an all-time low, you can own more homes than ever before. From start to finish, Century Homes can make your dreams come true.
Are we ready for some football?
Coach, we're ready for some ice and Ben Gay.
ESPN's College Football Saturday, brought to you by the next Ford F-150, built for tough, and by Gateway, 50 new products and three ways to get there. That's the way things should be.
On the bank to the Iowa River, the Hawkeyes leading Minnesota 10-6 here at Kinnick Stadium, 8:58 to go in the first half, a game in which Minnesota has moved the ball pretty well, Bob. We were talking about it during the break, but kind of self-destructed on that last drive in the red zone.
And injuries starting to pile up for Iowa, Mark, inside at those defensive tackle positions.
There's Maroney. Cuts it up inside, brought down shy of a 30 by Helms. Let's go downstairs for more from Holly.
Hey, guys, both defensive tackles for Iowa are out right now. Derek Robinson with a high left ankle sprain, and Jared Klaus also with a left ankle sprain.
They are trying to get both players back. We expect them to come back into the game. But right now, Tyler Lubke in for Derek Robinson. Jory Helms, also a backup for Jared Klaus. He is in the game right now. We'll see how they can hold up against this Minnesota running game.
All right, second down and eight. Ellison couldn't hang on to it at the 50-yard line. You know, Hawley talked about the two injuries a moment ago, Bob. That really underscores the fantastic coaching job that Kirk Ferentz has done this year at Iowa. Last year, AP Coach of the Year. A lot of people would feel that he might have done an even better coaching job this year, maneuvering his way around a lot of those minefields and injuries they've suffered. Depth has been a bit of an issue, but here they are, 7-3. Third down and eight. Abdul Khalik behind Patterson, but complete for the first down at the 43-yard line. Tony Patterson, a 6'2 senior for the Gophers.
Iowa again playing man under coverage. You're going to get Bob Sanders, 33, locked up again. Bob Sanders looking back into the backfield instead of playing man-to-man, burning his eyes on Tony Patterson. Mark, we see it over and over. Look at the receiver when you're playing man-to-man coverage.
Here they come out of the eye after that 12-yard gain. Ellison on the reverse. Ellison out near midfield at the 49-yard line. Reese Davis, tell us something.
All right, Mark, we got a couple of things to tell you. Mississippi State and Tennessee Volunteers up 7-0. Third and seven play, and the Dogs, Kevin Spant, finding Justin Jenkins. Nice grab and catch, and tied up at 7. And apparently A&M is waiting on basketball season or something. 16-0, about halfway through the first.
I hope Pinkler's trying to run up that score. Oh, enough of that.
The next controversy.
Enough of that. On second and five, Maroney brought down from behind. Nice tackle by Abdul Hodge, but there's a flag down on the play. With just a couple of weeks to go in this Big Ten season, so much still to be determined. Ohio State, Michigan, and Purdue all with one loss. Ohio State hosting Purdue this afternoon. Minnesota in that next tier of teams at 5-2. 9-2 overall.
I'll tell you what, Michigan better be careful going into Northwestern today. Northwestern's an improved football team. They can run the football. They're playing better defense. That would not shock me.
You think maybe looking ahead a little bit?
I don't know about that. Probably looking ahead a little bit, but I think Northwestern, particularly at home, is a difficult team to beat.
Got a lot of things going on, especially offensively. Michigan plays Ohio State after Northwestern this week. Ohio State with a huge one against Purdue today, and then at Ann Arbor.
And Ohio State still a shot, Mark. Stand up in the Nokia Sugar Bowl. Big win over Purdue, and Michigan might get them into the top two.
On second and 15, Abdul Khalik going up top, has a man. Incomplete. Broken up by Sean Considine. Considine has been a big specialty teams player this year and made a big pass breakup on that play.
Considine, a former walk-on right here. You see the size differential. Really an excellent job right there by Considine. Right there, get that left hand on the ball, Mark. And that's great position right there. Now you can look back to the quarterback when the ball's in the air. That is a tremendous play by Considine.
Guy who wasn't recruited. Northern Illinois didn't offer him. Was still close to him. Ended up walking on here at Iowa. Abdul Khalik has a man, complete to Hoshak. And Hoshak is tackled short of the first down to the 47-yard line. Well, we're talking about some of the great games to come in the Big Ten. Purdue takes on Ohio State. ABC's College Football Today at 3:30 regional action. That's the BCS Spotlight game. And number 25, Kansas State, is at Nebraska, North Carolina State at Florida State, and Arizona State at Washington State. Check the local listings for the game available in your area. I'm going to take Purdue in that game.
Well, first of all, let's talk about this front formation of Minnesota. They do the old style. I guess it's European rugby punt where you see Reese Floyd roll out to his right there.
There's no way that thing's going to go. Here's Ochoa. Ramon Ochoa brought down to the 28-yard line. Nice return on the 40-yard punt. Iowa with the ball on senior day. 24 of them playing their last home game. Back after this.
Hey, boys, your kitchen's on fire. You realize that, don't you? We're doing a 1010-987 commercial. Have you used 1010-987?
I never get out of the kitchen.
Well, you have to start. You call anywhere in the United States,
all Western Europe, Canada,
3 cents a minute, 39 cents to connect.
I really don't make that many calls.
It doesn't matter. You make one call, make 100 calls, 3 cents a minute. Where are you from?
El Salvador.
El Salvador.
Mm-hmm.
You call there quite often?
Yeah, every weekend.
1010-987. It's a very cheap rate.
Check the internet.
You know, I used to be a cook.
Whoa!
You burned my tomatoes!
Oh, my God.
If trips to you mean suitcases on rollers, if your dining guide isn't a gas food lodging sign, if you don't get beyond two-day growth, or ever use a tanker truck as a vanity mirror, get out of the way. Traditional styling, modern engineering, the Suzuki Volusia, get out of the way. XM Satellite Radio.
Point, Carol.
100 digital channels you'll never want to be without. It's music, sports, news, and talk. Many commercial free for under $10 a month. XM Satellite Radio.
Hawkeyes coming in at 7-3, Minnesota at 9-2, looking for their first 10-win season since 1905. But Bob, one of the big stories so far, Nathan Chandler with a hot hand passing.
Mark, I think great point. I mean, Iowa's plan, obviously, play action passing. They've only run the football for 32 yards, so they've decided that play action is their best opportunity to move this football against Minnesota.
First down and 10, Jermell Lewis. Lewis, nothing doing, nobody. Terrence Campbell has been everywhere. With another tackle, his fifth for the day, another one for loss.
And Mark, Jermell Lewis is an interesting story. Number 22, Iowa's tailback. Last spring, a knee injury, had an ACL. He's back. Remarkable comeback to be back this quick. Last week against Purdue, 7 carries for 56 yards. He only has 18 carries on the season, but he's back, healthy. You see last year's statistics, 709 yards rushing.
Had 101 against this Minnesota defense a year ago. Second down and 15 out of the shotgun. It's Lewis. Lewis brought down just shy of the 30 at the 29. You talk about his surgery. The doctors initially said that it would take him at least 9 months to come back from that ACL surgery. He was back on the field in a little less than 7 months.
What you see, Mark, is guys with great leg strength. He squats 615 pounds. So those guys with that kind of leg strength usually bounce back much quicker.
And Chris Doyle, their strength coach, does tremendous work with this team. Third down and 10. Chandler. Davis complete for the first down of the 47-yard line. He got in behind Yuki Dozier.
Mark, and Minnesota again goes to the robber scheme. And I want to show you what this is. It's man under, and they're going to drop the safety down in the hole. But what it does, it leaves the wide receiver on the corner man to man. You see right there, that corner at the top is completely on his own. And the underthrown fade is the most difficult route to defend against man-to-man. But maybe going to the robber coverage a little too often right there, leaving that corner one-on-one.
25-yard pickup, Bob, and here we go into the boundary, Jermell Lewis. Lewis with a nice game down to the 40-yard line, got about six. Dozier making the tackle. Jermell Lewis out of Plainville, Connecticut.
And one of the things Kenny O'Keefe told us yesterday, having Jermell Lewis back gives them great flexibility in their one-back attack, because normally when Freddie Russell's in there, it's all run. If Edgar Cervantes, the fullback, in there, it's all pass. Jermell gives them a chance to do both. He can catch, he can block, and he can run. So him in that one-back set doesn't tip off the defense. They have to play all three phases, Mark.
Right now it's Lewis in there, the single back, and they pass it. Complete to Ochoa, who's having an outstanding afternoon. A man from Maywood, California, one of those 24 seniors playing his final home game. And Kirk Barron talked to us about
how early in the recruitment process traveled out to California to visit with Ochoa and his parents. His parents, Spanish speaking, didn't speak the language. But it's interesting how football transcends a lot of cultural barriers.
Great point.
Got them locked up.
It's been an unbelievable journey for Ramon Ochoa from California to Iowa City. And you saw the emotion before the game when his family was introduced.
First down and 10. They run it into the boundary. Lewis has his team. And score his feet. Jamel Lewis. Touchdown, Hawkeyes. Iowa says, you know what? We're pretty good at running this zone play, too. Jamel Lewis, Ramon Ochoa, Mark, get the block down the field. But Iowa thinks they're the ones that run the zone play. And that time, it's hard to argue with them. Great job, Jamel Lewis back. Gives them another dimension, Mark. Tough to tell who really does have the best rush offense in the nation. Jamel Lewis with his first rushing touchdown this year. Ninth of his career, Kaeding. Knocked through the extra point. And the Iowa Hawkeyes, courtesy of that burst across the Iowa plains, 34 yards in all, lead 17-6 with 3:40 to go in the first half.
Mark, we're going to take a look right here at the zone play. Iowa doesn't pull linemen. They run the conventional zone. So Gallery's going to come off. The second point is downfield right here. You see little Ramon Ochoa biting at the ankles of Tremaine Banks. And Jamel Lewis takes it down the sideline. But Iowa in their zone blocking scheme, not a lot of moving parts, Mark, with linemen pulling. They really block with two linemen adjacent to each other, combo blocking off.
Coach Ferentz told us that the real center point of this rebuilding job that he's done at Iowa has focused on the offensive line. It's led to nice runs like that by Lewis, but with this incredible turnaround from 1-10 in his first year to last year where they went 11-2, he started in the trenches with the big guys up front. Seniors like Gallery leading the way. Here's Kaeding with the pick. And Minnesota will start off on its own 20. Well, we got two great matchups in prime time on ESPN and ESPN2 tonight. At 7 on ESPN2, number 16 Pittsburgh taking on West Virginia. Quincy Wilson with one of the great runs this year. You saw that highlight against Miami. And then, of course, there's always Larry Fitzgerald. Michigan takes on Northwestern on ESPN at 3:30 Eastern time. And LSU taking on Alabama.
I think Larry Fitzgerald has the stage set to make a run at it. He has these games on national television. Great opportunity. But I'll tell you what, Pitt better watch West Virginia, because West Virginia, Mark, can run the football.
They're a lot of good things. Maroney knocked out of bounds at the 24, and let's go to Reese Davis.
Mark, after Derrick Hensley scored the lone touchdown for the Volunteers against Miami last week, Phil Fulmer said got to get him the ball more often. Against Mississippi State, Casey Carson does just that. Hensley into the end zone. The well-thrown ball falls up by 7.
It'll be no letdown after that big win last week against Miami in the Orange Bowl. And Minnesota, a crew that averages over 40 points per game, being held to just 6 right now with 3:35 to go in the first half. Maroney with a short side of the field. Got the first down at the 31-yard line. Lawrence Maroney came into this Minnesota program with a lot of brashness and bravado, like a lot of freshmen, and he's toned it down a little bit and been very productive on the field.
You're right, Mark. And Minnesota running a little different play here where the fullback goes weak, the tailback starts strong, and then comes weak. It's a little bit of a counteraction. And an excellent block right there by Thomas DePay on the defensive end. So a little different wrinkle for Minnesota. We haven't seen that play.
On first and 10, Abdul Khalid has a man behind the defense complete. Ellison still on his feet and inbound. Ellison down to the 3-yard line, finally tackled by Johnson. A huge strike by the Gophers.
Well, unbelievable play, Mark. But it all starts with the quarterback, Abdul Khalid, escaped
Matt Ross in the backfield to stay alive.
God, Abdul-Khalik, great play.
And right here, I want you to watch the center, Esslinger, as this play develops. Give great effort to push Matt Ross by the play. Assad steps up, hits Jared Ellison down the sidelines over the top of Joe Von Johnson.
And we are looking at first down and goal. Maroney stopped by Matt Ross at the 2-yard line. Minnesota with an extremely productive offense this year. They have hung their hat on Assad Abdul-Khalik, who ranks in the top five of virtually every quarterbacking category this year and has just set the school record for total yardage.
And Mark, they love option down here on the goal line, the zone option. But with the injury to Assad Abdul-Khalik, I'm not sure if they'll come back with the option, but this is a great position for them.
They fumbled in the red zone the last time they got to this point. That's Patterson in motion. Maroney, touchdown Minnesota, and he fumbled it. They're going to say he didn't get in. Iowa ball. Wow.
Mark, we know the rule. If the tip of that football crosses the plane of the goal line, it's a touchdown. Right here, we're going to see Maroney. Bob Sanders punched that football out. From my angle, that looked like an excellent call right there.
Bob Sanders, the senior, punched it loose and recovered it at the 1-yard line. So for the second consecutive time, the Gophers pop it up in the red zone. On first and 10, Chandler keeps it himself. It appeared as if one of the officials was signaling touchdown at the near side, but it clearly was a fumble. That's what I saw from our vantage point.
Again, Lawrence Maroney, an outstanding back, but he is a freshman, Mark, and not protecting the ball on the goal line.
There was no illegal snap. Good play, second down.
Let's go to Reese in the studio.
All right, Mark, coming up on the Miller Highlights Halftime Report 7, Mark will join me. Joe Paterno's in search of his first Big Ten win of the season.
We'll talk, guys, about how Miami is handling their quarterback situation. Are they doing the right thing? Starting Derek Crudup, now Brock Berland, now back to Derek Crudup. What are they doing?
It's tough to question Larry Coker at 31-3, but I think I will at halftime.
It's a little bit confusing. We'll talk about that, update you on the SEC East, which might get weirder.
All right, and Reese, speaking of weird things, like the Minnesota offense has been in the Bermuda Triangle when they get in that red zone. Let's go back to that fumble a few moments ago by Maroney, punched loose by Sanders.
Lawrence Maroney again, Mark. It's hard to see, obviously. We don't have the camera angle right on the plane of that goal line, but it looked like an excellent call to me. The fifth-year senior, Bob Sanders, punching the football out from a freshman running back.
And during the course of this Big Ten conference season, the officials in the conference at large are reviewing the pluses and minuses, the benefits, what have you, of a replay-type system formatted along the lines of the NFL, and they'll be looking at that with an eye towards the future.
First of all, clock operator, put 2 minutes and 6 seconds on the clock. 206 on the clock. Because there was no foul in the play, we're putting the ball back to the spot, the previous spot. It'll be first down.
One more angle.
That ball is definitely out. Excellent call by the Big Ten crew right there. Iowa's ball. Now the story becomes, Mark, Minnesota with 3 timeouts left in the first half, 2 minutes and 6 seconds left. Minnesota, if they can stop, he's going to have great field position.
They'll get something out of the defense right here. Chandler keeps it again, and another flag.
Fires to the snap. Ball start. Offense. It's going to be half position for the goal. Full first down.
Now, Iowa's offense imploding a little bit with 2:06 to go in the half.
Going back to Minnesota's offense, though, Mark, only 11 turnovers all year coming into this football game. So, uncharacteristically, turning the football over. We saw on the previous possession, they had the ball down in the red zone. They gave up a sack. They came into the game, only had given up 11 sacks. So, those things happening on the road is not a good sign for Minnesota. Russell the deep back out of the eye. Chandler trying to pull him offside. They can't move the ball back anymore. What are you doing?
You got to figure out half the distance with goal line, Mark.
You need a microscope now if you're going to figure out half the distance.
And obviously,
in spot. Go first down.
Nathan Chandler trying to draw Minnesota offside right there, but another delay of game penalty. Minnesota still with three timeouts.
They keep moving it back. It's going to be a safety.
Yeah, the next penalty is a blade of grass. Distance. Still first down and 10. Tried to hit him with the old okey-doke a couple times. And Chandler, if you're 6'7", Bob, and you fall forward, that's a two-yard gain, right, at least.
Mark, I think you're right.
And a timeout on the field called by Minnesota. Both teams with two timeouts remaining. Minnesota hoping to stem the tide and get the ball back before the end of the half. We'll be back.
Chuck has so much potential as a singer.
I had no musical background whatsoever.
Yeah, a little attitude, ah.
And look at me now.
The sky is the limit if Chuck wants to become a professional singer.
If a man would fail.
Great voice.
I found encouragement. The one-on-one with my teacher is awesome.
His musical skills have improved so much.
Dr. Everly encouraged me to find my personal best. That's the University of Iowa.
Second down and 8 to go for the Iowa Hawkeyes, operating within the shadows of their own goalposts. Nose of the ball resting at the 3-yard line. Minnesota hoping to get a stop here and get the ball back.
And Mark, without Mo Brown in the game, I don't think you're going to see a play action pass come on.
Chandler, big completion out to the 25-yard line to Matt Malloy. Gets him a little bit of breathing room with 1:53 to go in the half.
Iowa brought Matt Malloy across in motion, then ran him by the corner right there. Big, big play from a field position standpoint.
Bob, Chandler seems to throw better on the move as opposed to standing in the pocket.
No question, Mark. And a little bit of a surprise right there. I mentioned Mo Brown not in the game, Ramon Ochoa not in the game. They throw it to Matt Malloy right there, and it's got Minnesota off guard.
Out of the eye, Chandler. This time from the pocket for Brown. Incomplete at the 30-yard line. Broken up by Eli Ward.
Tell you what, could have been pass interference right there as Tremaine Banks was stumbling and went down the leg right here. Gets there early. Probably a good no call, Mark. One thing you see, Minnesota with smaller players in the secondary, particularly at safety, those jump balls, really for both teams today, are pretty good percentage plays down the field.
Eichen at 5'8", and Ward at about 5'11". Back. Second down and 10. Quick drop, incomplete. There's 1:20 to go in the half. Let's go to Holly.
Hey, guys, stick around with us. Coming up after the half, here's the big moment you've all been waiting for. They actually bring Floyd, the 100-pound statue of a pig, down to the field so the players can see it and actually see what they're playing for here in the second half. You won't want to miss it.
All right, Holly. Right now, Floyd just chilling out in the locker room. But both these teams have said that we don't want the other side coming over our bench going to get that thing. Part of the motivation, amongst other things, for today's game. Iowa 2-of-8 on third down today. Chandler, backside pressure, got it away, but it's incomplete. With 1:15 to go, the Minnesota Gophers will get the ball back. It was intended for Mo Brown, but good pressure by Eric Clark.
Good change-up call by Greg Hudson, Mark. Playing a lot of man under coverage. That time went with the 2D zone coverage. They got good pressure. They have a chance to get the football back. A minute 15, two timeouts.
Marion Barber, though, not in the game as the punt returner.
Quentin White from Minnesota standing at his own 34. Bradley sitting up on his own 12. Coming after it a little bit. Bradley gets off a booming punt over White's head. And here's White on the return. Takes it out to the 13. We've seen a little bit of everything in this first half of play. But a 74-yard punt by Bradley. Hey, anything in the air that long, Bob, should have a movie on it. What a kick. Mark, we're going to see if this is a touchback or not. It looks like it should be a touchback, and the ball should come out to the 20. I don't believe Bob Sanders had possession of that football, Mark. That should come back out to the 20-yard line.
White alertly picked it up and tried to maybe catch the defender's off guard.
The punt was in the end zone. It's all untouched by the receivers. The result of the play is a touchback. Ball is put on the 20-yard line.
Mark, let's go back and look at this one more time. That's a good call by the officials of getting together, talking that over, bringing the ball out to the 20.
As a result, 80 yards to go for Asad Abdul-Khalik. Under a minute to go here in the first half. Minnesota with two timeouts remaining. Lawrence Maroney, the man who fumbled right near the end zone a few moments ago on offense. Let's go back to Holly downstairs.
Well, guys, Lawrence Maroney was a pretty lonely guy on the sideline after that fumble at about the one-inch line. He was standing there by himself for several minutes. Finally, their senior leader and captain, Asad Abdul-Khalik, came over and spent the next 5 minutes talking with him, trying to reassure him, tell him you can't worry about things. Go back out there with your head up and make something happen.
At this point, trying to encourage him, just a freshman, Holly. Asad Abdul-Khalik, meanwhile, throws it away.
Now it flips back the pressure on Minnesota's offense. Iowa still with two timeouts left in the half, 30 seconds to go. So now it flips to where if Iowa can stop this third and 10, they have a chance for great field position. And Iowa, Mark, a punt block team. Sean Considine blocked two himself. Iowa's blocked four on the year.
Don't forget, folks, coming up, it's the Miller Highlights Halftime Report. We've got Mark in the studio breaking it down for you. Minnesota out to the 22-yard line. Maroney brought down that time by Howard Hodges. Another one of those seniors playing his final home game. Iowa uses a timeout. In last year's game, it was all Fred Russell and the Hawkeyes all the time, early and often. That's what they were playing for. Floyd of Rosedale, just like this year, Russell was in full speed, full gear. The turbo kicked in. And Brad Banks was masterful to Mo Brown in control of that offense. And after the game, this was one of the best scenes all year in college football. The Iowa fans trying to carry the goalposts out of the stadium, Bob.
Yeah, one of the best scenes if you're an Iowa fan or an Iowa player. But think about, on the other hand, you're a Minnesota fan just trying to go home after getting whipped in the Metrodome. You got some guy carrying a goalpost by you trying to exit the Metrodome. And you're a Minnesota player. Don't think that that didn't stir some emotion with those Minnesota players. Iowa coming in there and celebrating.
A lot of Minnesota fans, Bob, making the trip 4 hours away on the interstate to Iowa City.
And Mark, we talked earlier about Reed Floyd, the rugby-style punter from Minnesota, takes the snap, will roll to his right, punts the football on the run. Keep in mind, Iowa blocked one against Michigan this year in a similar style punt.
Tom Considine, the guy to watch, number 37. He's blocked two of them this year. Floyd rolls out, just got it off in time. A low line drive. Ochoa on the return. Razor Ochoa down to the 49-yard line with 14 seconds to go. A 39-yard punt. A 7-yard return by Ochoa. We have a flag down back at the 17-yard line. So hold on a minute. It's holding against Minnesota.
They came after that one, though. Mark, they're going to come back and come after the next one, too. And we're going to get a chance to watch.
Holding. On the kicking team. Can you tell me from the previous spot? Go for it down. Clock will start on a snap. On a
Mark,
snap.
What I would do, they brought the corner off the gunner right here from the outside to put pressure with the angle that the football was being punished. Also, great pressure with Matt Malloy, number 84, in the number two position.
At least Lloyd has said that he's always punted that way, rolling out to his right. They decided not to try and change him when he arrived in Minnesota this year.
Keep an eye on Jovan Johnson right here and Matt Malloy, these two outside rushers. But Minnesota brought their gunner in to be in a punt protection position.
They changed up the formation a little bit. Under heat again, got off a high but short punt. Ochoa fumbled it and then got it back. An even better field position this time for the Hawkeyes, Bob, at the 37-yard line with 7 seconds to go on that 25-yard punt. You try running a play, then kicking?
I think so, Mark. 7 seconds, I would throw a three-step drop. You don't need a lot of yardage to get Nate Kaeding in field goal position, particularly because he has the wind at his back. So look for a three-step drop, the ball thrown on the sideline. Try to get him a little bit closer, because right now it would be a 54-yard field goal attempt. I think Kirk Ferentz is going to call timeout and talk this over. 7 seconds, you're right at the critical position right here.
And Iowa now burning its final timeout, leading 17-6. The number one rush offense in the entire nation right now, with just 6 points on the board. The number five total offense in the nation with just 6 points, largely because of turnovers. Nate Kaeding, meanwhile, Bob, this offense has so many great kickers. We've seen Ben Jones at Purdue. We've seen Kaeding. We've seen Reese Floyd here. And Kaeding is a guy that, during the summer, drew on the experience of one Jan Stenerud. It's paid off. You look at his numbers.
Yeah, he needs a little Jan Stenerud right now, Mark. He's going to try a 54-yarder, I believe, right here. Actually, a 55-yarder. But he has the wind at his back. The ball is in the middle of the football field. I'm going to go on a limb. He's going to make this field goal right here. Senior day in the stadium. Wind at his back. Ball's in the middle. He's only missed one all year.
Nate Kaeding from 65 yards out. They feel it. That would have been good from 65. Nate Kaeding lighting up Pinnock Stadium. He ties his career long of 55 yards.
This kid is a unique personality. He just snapped a little bit high, but Mark, he just drilled this, and then, I mean, he chased it the length of the football field. Now he's out in the middle of the football field getting this crowd excited.
A kicker with the linebacker-type mentality, Nate Kaeding, who was bragging on me about his bench press of 230 pounds. Now let's go downstairs to Holly for more.
Hey guys, this is a kid who knows how to, in high school, he won the state championship in basketball as a starter, in soccer as a starter, and 2 times in football as a starter. But he is a little cocky. Before the game, he said, hey, would you tell Bob Davey to quit jinxing me? When I get out there, I want him to say, this kid is the worst kicker in the nation. Both times he has missed a field goal, last year and this year, it was because we were here.
That was Mark Jones that jinxed him, but go back to the holding penalty on the punt by Minnesota. They had to re-punt it.
Well, that's the end of the first half. Nate Kaeding lighting up Kinnick Stadium. Coming up at halftime, the Miller High Life halftime report. Reese, Mark, and Trev in the studio, 20-6 at the break. And Reese, that guy's shoe might be corked. I don't know.
It's very possible. It looks a lot like a Grozer shoe again for Nate Kaeding. 20-6, Iowa with the lead in the battle for Floyd of Rosedale. Coming up on the Miller High Life halftime report. Berlin calling, Berlin out, Krudup in, Krudup out. What is going on down in Miami with their quarterback situation? We'll try to decipher it against Syracuse. Some shuffling going on back there, and the Hurricanes are getting a bit of a fight. as that good ship Gator suddenly swung a leap at quarterback. The Gamecocks are not cooperating and trying to mess up that SEC tiebreaker thing. And Joe Paterno says that this won't be his final home game. Nittany Lions trying to give him a win.
ESPN The Magazine on Newsstand Now.
Where most minivans score an F on the report card is in the versatility of their interiors. Yet this is where Freestar earns an A. For its ease of use. So the next time you hear the term interior flexibility, that's what they're talking about.
That's smart engineering.
The all-new Ford Freestar. If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
Flint's got wireless and wireline integrated, man. It's just one seamless network.
Yeah, but we're meeting with AT&T.
And AT&T Wireless.
Huh?
Hi. Hello. How you doing?
Hi.
How long are you?
AT&T.
AT&T Wireless.
So when do we meet with Sprint?
Two guys, one suit, should have seen it. Sometimes seeing is believing.
Get integrated wireline and wireless services from one company. Get the facts at Sprint.com. One Sprint, many solutions.
Big Ten football is a special tradition.
Medical Center in Centerville, the skill to heal, the spirit to care.
Iowa Trust and Savings Bank, a locally owned community bank serving the Centerville community and surrounding area since 1896. Iowa Trust and Savings Bank is proud to offer all the products and services of larger financial institutions. Our uniqueness is our employees. Our friendly service allows you to complete all your banking fast, with employees who are ready yet smart to help you with all of your banking needs. Iowa Trust and Savings Bank, proudly serving our community.
This halftime report brought to you by Miller High Life. To live simply, proudly, boldly, manly, this is the highlight.
Had a lot of conversation about what will happen if the SEC remains tied. Three teams with two losses. Everybody wins out. Of course, for Florida, Georgia, and Tennessee, all that would get messed up if someone lost, like, say, maybe the Gators on the road in Columbia to take on South Carolina. And deep in its own end, Chris Leak doesn't get rid of the ball, doesn't get out of the end zone.
We've marveled at his maturity as the season's progressed. Right there, he just got to get rid of the football. And what a beautiful run right here. South Carolina, Dak is determined, takes the handoff, the vision to cut back, gets it all the way inside the five of Florida.
But Corey Boyd right here will blast in. Look at that formation, just pushing the pile back into the end zone.
South Carolina, 9-0. And the Gamecock defense controlled play for much of the first half, but deep in the first half, Leak dancing into the end zone, and the Mighty Crocodiles of the Zucker on the road. They won three SEC games on the road this year, 3-0, but they're down, getting very deep in the half, but it's a 9-7 game at the moment. Mississippi State and Tennessee, the Volunteer offense didn't do a lot against Miami. This is the perfect game to get well. Mississippi State hasn't stopped anyone. Casey Clawson, Chris Hannon, 7-0 Volunteers. The Bulldog offense finds a little bit of life. Kevin Fant and Justin Jenkins.
Nice job by Justin Jenkins. Going up for the ball, then knowing where the goal line is, diving in for the score, tying the score 7-7.
Casey Clawson finds Derek Tinsley. Fulmer said this week, got to get Tinsley more involved in the offense. He scored the touchdown against Miami, ended up winning the game last week. Then Jabari Davis on the ground, started to go into launch mode there and go into orbit, decided he didn't need to, stayed on the ground, made it to the checkerboard. 21-7. They're still playing in the second quarter, and the Volunteers have seen
Mississippi State
well under control. Mississippi State has shown up, unlike last week against Alabama. Syracuse and Miami. Derek Kluter starting for Brock Berlin. Kellen Winslow did not start this game either. Well, this is the bugaboo that taunted Berlin, turning the ball over, Cruder throwing the pick that would lead to a Syracuse field goal. Winslow entered the game with a 1:45 to go in the first quarter. First play action again, Cruder finds Ryan Moore.
Cruder did a nice job of looking to the left, coming back to the right, finding Ryan Moore wide open. Obviously a mistake in coverage for Syracuse.
Ryan slamming it into the end zone for Syracuse. The Orange wouldn't back down. Last three meetings between these two teams, Syracuse has been outscored 134-7. But at the moment, the Orange with a three-point lead in the Orange Bowl. They've just started the second half. We're going to keep an eye on that for you as Syracuse trying to continue reeling Miami Hurricanes problems. Virginia Tech and Temple. Virginia Tech lost a heartbreaker to Pittsburgh last week. They've got a 3-0 lead in Philadelphia over the Owls. All right, guys, let's talk a little bit about this Miami quarterback situation. We saw Derek Crudup in the highlights, but he didn't play the entire first half, but Berlin came in too.
And for Larry Coker, this is a problem. This is quarterback you were talking about, where you've got quarterbacks that come out of there and go to the NFL and have great careers. Well, right now, they don't have a starting quarterback. And for Larry Coker, the head coach, he has to decide which one of his quarterbacks will be the starter. I don't think it's fair to put a Derek Crudup into the ballgame. You've got the lead at 10-7, and you're pulled? Give your quarterback a chance. They're only down. They were down by 3 points in this game. Give your quarterback a chance to operate the offense and at least move the offense for an entire half. He didn't even have an entire half.
I think you have to look deeper for this football team, guys, in terms of what their problems are offensively. We always focus on the quarterback, and surely you can look at the quarterback and mistakes that they're making. But if you look at Miami's offense, I think Brock Berlin took too much heat for this offense. They haven't scored a rushing touchdown in four of the last five games. Miami's offense has always been and always will be predicated on running the football first. They have to get back to running the football. If you look at another situation, I think they're completely different than a situation at Virginia Tech, where all of a sudden their quarterbacks are struggling because they are getting consistent running from Tevin Jones. The quarterbacks at Virginia Tech should be pulled. Brian Randall should be pulled because they're getting consistent running game out of Tevin Jones. At Miami, no consistent running game. I don't care who they throw a quarterback. They get Bernie Kosar back there. If they can't run the football, they're not going to be able to throw and protect the quarterback.
Well, Bernie is on the sideline today, but I don't think they're going to let him play. The problem with Berlin, he's been responsible for 17 of their 27 turnovers, and we aren't aware of any problem with Crudup, which would have caused him to come out of the game, but he did turn the ball over a couple of times. We will continue on the Miller Highlights Halftime Report. We will take a look ahead to Joe Paterno and see what's going on with the Nittany Lions. Hawkeyes up big at the half.
Where's the line between you and everyone else? You sense it shifting, blurring, fading. So you question things. Think about things. You don't settle. You don't compromise. You don't want to buck the system. You just want to give it a little nudge. We get that. At Miller, we don't compromise either. It's why we cold filter Miller Genuine Draft for the fresh, smooth taste of draft beer. It's why we created the first light beer. The beer that's great tasting and less filling. Because at Miller, we believe there's good enough, and there's better than it has to be. Miller, good call.
Men don't like to shave. They'd rather light their shorts on fire or eat dirt. Easy, fellas. Nivea soothes the pain of shaving. With moisturizers and vitamins, Nivea for Men Aftershave Bomb soothes and improves. Nivea for Men, more evolved skincare.
Benny Wallace, wrong direction, bro.
Come on, sir.
Let me tell you something. ESPN NBA basketball. I've lived the 24/7 mode, and I've achieved the ISO motion. Rated everyone.
Back on the Miller High Life Halftime Report, and Joe Paterno has been adamant that this will not be his final home game at Beaver Stadium in Happy Valley. Penn State taking on Indiana this afternoon. Paterno in a six-game losing streak, unprecedented in his career, and one more loss for the Nittany Lions would be the most in the storied history of their 117 years of football in state college. Penn State got off to a little bit of a rocky start. No team has thrown fewer touchdown passes this year than Indiana. And Indiana threw a touchdown pass, LaVecchio to Glenn Johnson, but Zach Mills answers to Tony Johnson. If your name's Johnson, please stand in the highlight and catch a touchdown pass. Tony Jansen with another one. Now, your name is Maurice Humphrey. Catch a touchdown pass.
Zach Mills is out. He's hot. I mean, Indiana's defense is terrible in pass defense. And Zach Mills has played very well. Rolling out, throwing on a run, sitting in the pocket. Impressive Zach Mills, the quarterback, guys.
The Penn State trying to get his first Big Ten win of the season. 21-7, they are up on Indiana. Wisconsin, since that Ohio State game, pretty much downhill. Actually, not downhill, right off the edge of the Wiley-Coyote cliff against Michigan State. Jeff Smoker. Oh, you just don't throw it at Jim Leonard like that. Jim Leonard will pick you off. That's his sixth interception of the year. That led to a Wayne Smith touchdown, 14-0. Here is Lee Evans. Lee Evans coming up huge. 75-yard touchdown catch right there. Lee Evans with 7 catches and 3 touchdowns, 160 yards. Here those two guys getting together again, baby.
Nice play action fake. And look at Lee Evans again. Coming across on the post pattern. Great concentration on the reception. Lee Evans in the house against the account.
What did they eat this morning?
Well, they arrived. This is the Badger team we saw for a stretch earlier in the season, not the Michigan State team we saw when they were playing a little bit better. Later on this afternoon, the Michigan Wolverines, one more stumble to avoid before the showdown with Ohio State next week. Michigan gets Northwestern, and John Navarre has an opportunity to become just the third quarterback in Michigan history to notch 30 victories as a starter, joining Ricky the Peach Leach and Elvis Gerback. But if you're going to talk about Michigan, and you're going to talk about Northwestern, it's a Big Ten. You've got to keep it on the ground. Jeff Hollinger and Andre Ware will have the call for it.
The middle of November brings a dark day to Chicagoland, but today the lights will be shining brightly on Ryan Field in Evanston as number 5 Michigan on the road versus improving Northwestern. It is indeed a house divided. Welcome, everyone. I'm Jeff Hollinger along with former Heisman Trophy winner Andre Ware. And for the Wildcats to have any success here on their home field, they're going to have to find a way to slow down Chris Perry. He's got over 1,300 yards rushing this season.
Just a phenomenal back a couple of weeks ago against arch rival Michigan State. 51 carries, 219 yards, and a touchdown. Just outstanding. When most backs this time of year seem to be wearing down, he gets stronger as the season goes. In good inside, good outside runner with speed to take it the distance.
51 carries is staggering.
Unbelievable.
For Northwestern, they're doing a better job in the time of possession department. They were last in the Big Ten in 2002. But this year, they're 6 minutes better, and that is really saying something.
They've gone away from the no-huddle, which they were exclusive last year with, and it's allowed them to keep the defense off the field, give themselves more possession time. And it's worked for him the last couple of weeks, winning 3 out of the last 4 ball games.
Randy Walker of Northwestern loves gadget plays. Some trickery in store for Michigan today, you can be sure of that.
Yes, we've seen the fastball. We've seen the changeup maybe in store for the slider or the curveball this afternoon.
Well, the hope is that Northwestern will not strike out against number 5 Michigan. Ryan Field in Chicagoland, the Wolverines and the Wildcats. Now back to you.
All right, guys, we will look forward to that coming up in just a little while. Right now, we got to settle who's going to take home Floyd of Rosedale. Nathan Chandler's hoping Iowa will keep the pig 20-6. Hawkeyes on top.
Hey.
I just wanted to say
I love you. Same here. You know, me too.
Ditto.
Hello?
When you can't say it, show it. The Nokia 3650 camera phone. The new love letter.
In the red zone, the best way to defend against the play is to stop it before it starts. That's why I use new red zone deodorant from Old Spice.
Red zone's new odor defense system helps stop odor before it starts. And the scent lasts longer than the leading brand.
New red zone deodorant from Old Spice.
I'm shooting high, got my eyes on a star in the sky.
Body sprays from Old Spice. Spray it on in the morning. Spice things up.
Nice package.
Body sprays from Old Spice. Spice things up.
What I love about William Penn is the family atmosphere that we have here on the campus and the relationship between our student body and our faculty. Because of the size of the school, it gives us a better opportunity to work with our teachers one-on-one and for our teachers also to get to know us as students as well as people too.
This halftime report brought to you by Miller High Life. To live simply, proudly, boldly, manly. This is the High Life.
What do you think the way Florida ended the first half against Tennessee a few weeks back? Bad way to end a half. Give up a Hail Mary for a touchdown. This is worse. Against South Carolina, a punt on the last play of the half. This is Chavez Donnie. Someone better tackle him, Mark.
Somebody get him. It's a huge momentum change for Florida in this game. Now South Carolina has the momentum going in at half.
How about Lou Holtz carrying a little momentum, bidding for the upset, and trying to become bowl eligible? That's something Texas A&M doesn't have to worry about. They're getting clobbered again at Missouri, 22-3 late in the first half. And Army, with the nation's longest active losing streak, is 12 in a row right now. Black Knights of the Hudson tied with Houston at 7. And Duke, after getting off the snide against Georgia Tech, In Death Valley and Clemson following up after the victory over Florida State. Clemson going for its 7th win. And what about Georgia Tech? You're right there on the verge of bowl eligibility. You get clobbered by Duke, and now North Carolina's on top. They've still got Virginia and Georgia to go. All of a sudden, Chan Gailey seems a little bit dicey situation. There's still plenty of time to go in that game between Carolina and Tech. Our game in the Big Ten, the battle for Floyd of Rosedale, and Nate Kaeding late in the first half kicked a field goal from Des Moines, I think, about 55 yards out. 20-6, Iowa has the lead. What about some second half adjustments now for Minnesota?
Well, I think what Glenn Mason has to do in the second half is, I know that they're the number one rush team in the country, but as a steady diet, you can't continue to run on first down. Change it up a little bit. Couple screens, couple draws, little play action pass. Move the ball around on first down. They're too predictable running the football.
It's absolutely imperative that Iowa win this football game.
Why?
Because last week, Minnesota won an axe. Yep. They won the Paul Bunyan axe, and if they win the pig, what happens when you get an axe and a pig together?
I think somebody's going to get
you're going to get some bacon.
Yeah, maybe sausage.
Iowa, do it for the pig, Hawkeyes.
I'll keep the axes away from you then.
I think what happens here is that PETA is in favor of your solution here. Iowa with the lead. I think Minnesota, they'd like to have the axe and the pig. Nate Kaeding is putting a kick into that thing, 55 yards out for number 95. Iowa with the big lead, second half coming.
Where's the line between you and everyone else? You sense it's shifting, blurring, fading. So you question things. You think about things. You don't settle. You don't compromise. You don't want to buck the system. You just want to give it a little nudge. We get that. At Miller, we don't compromise either. It's why we cold filter Miller Genuine Draft for the fresh, smooth taste of draft beer. It's why we created the first light beer, the beer that's great tasting and less filled. Because at Miller, we believe there's good enough, and there's better than it has to be. Miller. Good call.
When Taco Bell first created the Zesty Chicken Bowl, we thought we'd freshly prepare them right at your table. We still freshly prepare them, just not at your table. The Zesty Chicken Bowl, grilled all white meat chicken, seasoned rice, cheese, crisp lettuce, and fiesta salsa. Made right when you order it, so it tastes even better. For fresh made taste, think outside the bun.
Back in Iowa City, Iowa, at Kinnick Stadium, 24 Iowa Hawkeye seniors leaving their locker room here for the last time at home. 24 Iowa seniors who are the cornerstone of helping to turn around a program, a group that came in on the heels of a 3-9 season, right now looking to improve to 8-3 overall and looking at a nice bowl game, in fact. And Bob Davey, when you look ahead now to the second half of play, it's been a good first half for Iowa. How do they keep it up in the second half?
Well, they have to keep doing what they're doing, but I think Iowa has made a statement that they need to throw the football against this Minnesota defense. I'm a little surprised Iowa hasn't run the ball more. That field goal, 55 yards by Nate Kaeding at the end of the first half, huge. For Minnesota, missed opportunity. 271 total yards and only 6 points. Two turnovers, Mark, to put that in perspective, Minnesota only had 11 turnovers all year coming into this football game. But Minnesota is going to come roaring back in this game after this Iowa defense.
Mentioned they're going to have to do it without Marion Barber III, their leading rusher. Here they come on the opening kickoff of the third quarter. White out to the 23. Time now for our Gateway game track. What are they playing for? Floyd of Rosedale. The series has started back in 1935. It's Seniors Day, and a couple of shining on this play. Ramon Ochoa and Nathan Chandler. Nate Kaeding, another one of those 24 seniors, tying a career long with a 55-yard field goal near the end of the half. Minnesota, meanwhile, with a couple of fumbles inside the red zone. That added to a missed field goal in the first quarter. On the out and up, incomplete, intended for Jared Ellerson. Antoine Allen defending on the play.
Mark, another thing about the first half, I think this Big Ten officiating crew did a great job, but Jim Lapatina, the referee, there were a lot of bizarre things that took place in the first half. I think they did a great job controlling this football game. Also, Minnesota going into the wind here in the third quarter.
Minnesota with the number one rush offense in the country, but behind 20-6, you wonder how long they can afford to run it for. Ellerson on the reverse, rocked at the 23-yard line by Considine, and let's go down to Holly.
I was speaking with the coaches at halftime. Minnesota's Glenn Mason said he told his team in the locker room, look, we're down by 14, but we turned the ball over twice in the scoring position. He said they've got to eliminate mistakes. Marion Barber III definitely out for the second half with a groin injury. He also challenged his wide receivers to take advantage of that huge size differential over the corners of Iowa. For Kirk Ferentz of Iowa, his comments were simple. He said at this point, it's all about heart.
Third down and 12 on the opening drive of the third quarter for Minnesota.
Iowa showing blitz, Mark. Straight man-to-man blitz. Minnesota sees it coming.
Bob Sanders on the blitz, and it's a fumble. Loose ball. And the Hawkeyes have it again.
Wow, Mark. Three turnovers. This one may be the most damaging because the first series of the second half is so critical. They line Bob Sanders up in the slot. You see Asada Duclic talking right there to Maroney, the running back. If we can come back and take a look again at that again, you're going to see Sanders come off the slot. Maroney goes opposite right here. Bob Sanders, a nose for that football. Big, big turnover, Mark.
The one thing I've learned from Football 101, you always worry about freshmen when it comes to pass protection. They're only a freshman. Down and 10, coming back the other way. Fred Russell had a slow first half with just 5 yards rushing on four attempts. Got a couple the hard way there. Eli Ward, the starting strong safety, with the stop for Minnesota. Fred Russell, who has rushed for over 1,000 yards in back-to-back seasons, a little slow in the first half of play.
And Eli Ward, Minnesota's number one tackler, as the free safety came up that time and made a great tackle in the open field, Mark.
Lewis coming into the ballgame now, Bob, for Ward.
Again, the one-back set to give them flexibility because a good ball carry, a good pass protector, and a good receiver on screen passing.
They're going to pass on this one. Chandler, incomplete, intended for Tony Jackson, the backup tight end. It'll be third down and long. Third and 7. McKenzie in on the coverage that time for the Gophers. Nathan Chandler has been pretty good so far, 11 of 19 passing for 154 yards. Had that one interception early in the game, but
since that time has really settled down and shown a lot of poise.
And this Minnesota defense, they've struggled in forcing turnovers, Mark. Only have created 14 all year, 103rd in the country, and only 21 sacks, which puts them ninth in the Big Ten. So not a real pressure turnover type defense.
Iowa calls the timeout. With the ball on the 16-yard line, it'll be third down and seven when we come back. Iowa trying to put Minnesota in a big hole.
For decades, Quattro all-wheel drive has revolutionized racing. Now our advantage is yours in every model line. The Advantage Audi event. Take the advantage now. For exceptional values on exceptional cars, go to AudiUSA.com.
Auto insurance company. We've always gotten along okay, but let's say this is Allstate. Ooh, looks better than what you got now, huh? Well, qualified drivers who call Allstate for a free auto quote can get a company this good for this kind of price. Maybe less. The choice is pretty simple, don't you think? So call Allstate now for an auto quote and find out how you're in good hands with Allstate.
Iowa leading 20-6. Inside of that box is Floyd of Rosedale, the object of everyone's affections this afternoon. The 97th meeting between Iowa and Minnesota. They're playing for the pig today. It's been resting comfortably in the trophy case in Iowa City for the last 2 years running. Third down and seven, Jamel Lewis, the lone back behind Nathan Chandler. Mo Brown in the slot. Come with a blitz. Chandler. Incomplete. They came after him and forced the errant throw. Calvin Davis, the intended receiver, and in comes the field goal unit.
That time, Greg Hudson comes with a five-man rush, bringing Justin Frey, the linebacker, right up the gut right here. Play man-free coverage in behind it. Good pressure, forces, sets up a field goal situation again for Nate Kaeding, trying to make this, Mark, a 17-point football game.
This one coming from about 34 yards out. And Kaeding drills it through, now 3 of 3 on the day. A pitcher with a very strong leg and no doubt would appear to be an NFL draft choice next year.
And Mark, as this game progresses, you see how important it is for Minnesota. Get Lawrence Maroney, the young freshman running back, some confidence and involved in this game. With Marion Barber out, you're going with the young freshman, a great talent running the football, but so far today he's coughed the ball up on the 1 yard line. He went the wrong way on the pass protection where Bob Saunders forced the turnover. So really two turnovers today that can be somewhat attributed to inexperience. But no doubt this guy's a talent. But part of the learning process, as you mentioned, pass protection, ball security.
They do have four talented backs at Minnesota. Marona being one of them, Barber,
Thomas Pepe, who's seen action today, and Terry Jackson, somewhat of a forgotten guy at this point.
And a big part for a young player, overcoming adversity, Mark. How do you react when some bad things happen? So Lawrence Mosley right now, grow up here as this game progresses, turn a negative into a positive, make something positive happen.
Iowa with 20 unanswered points since trailing 3-0. This one into the end zone, and let's go downstairs to Holly.
Guys, I'm here with Floyd. He has not been unveiled. They're going to wait until the fourth quarter, but I'm here with Ron. We have actually been chatting. No one's actually ever tried to steal the pig, but they're going to keep him in the box just in case. He weighs 98.5 pounds, so it's not like you could get far with him. But after seeing what these Iowa fans did to the goalpost last year at Minnesota, I'm not so sure. So we're going to keep him in the box until the fourth quarter, guys.
All right, Holly. Floyd aging gracefully, 68 years old, but gaining a little weight, 98.5. He can't get out of the box that often. You know, except to work out.
I think you show a little more respect for a guy 68 years old. You got Holly and the state trooper sitting on his house down there.
That's got Abdul Khalif on the run. And Chad Greenway, the leading tackler in the conference, drags him down out of bounds.
Chad Greenway, Norm Parker, the defensive coordinator, told us best athlete on the team. And talking about Floyd the Pig, this guy's family raises hogs, Mark, in South Dakota. They have 4,000 hogs on that farm. His parents could not go to the Purdue game last week because they had a shipment of 600 new hogs coming in.
Got to handle those pigs. They got 100 cattle, too. That's a busy farm. Second down and 14 after the sack. It's Maroney. Hey, Reese, what's up with Kellen Winslow?
Well, he's been a busy young man this afternoon, Mark. Syracuse and Miami, Kellen Winslow coming in there, blocking the punt, getting the Hurricane set up deep in Syracuse territory, but Canes couldn't cash in. They turned it over on down. Winslow later dropped the pass, and two plays after dropping one, caught it, and fumbled. I know the young man's brought a lot of problems on himself, but he's having a rough day. Syracuse, 10-7.
Well, Minnesota reached back here, third down and long, 10 to go.
Iowa coming, Mark, with the same blitz they used last time. You see Bob Sanders right here.
And Maroney went the other way again. Here's a shot of Abdul Khalif. Locked down at the 27, short of the first down by about 3 yards. Howard Hodges makes the tackle on the play. And Minnesota's offense cannot stop the fire and fury of Bob Sanders.
And Mark, this time Minnesota slides the protection to the side of the blitzer to pick up the blitz. They put the offensive tackle on Bob Sanders. Good job right here by Assad Abdul-Khalik of getting something out of it. Again, it sets up the rugby-style punt by Reese Floyd.
It's off a good one away from Ochoa, but he gets to it at the 35. Ramon Ochoa on the loose. On senior day, one guy to beat. Lloyd saved himself a touchdown. Razor Ochoa cutting through that special teams coverage.
What a day for the senior, Ramon Ochoa. They call him Razor. He kind of razor bladed through there. And I got to ask you, do they tackle in rugby? I'm not a big rugby fan.
Well, he just learned there.
Reese Floyd right there gets him on the ground. But this game's getting out of hand right now for Minnesota.
Iowa back in good field position at the 25. First and 10.
Great position for play action pass right here, Mark.
You all know by now it's a staple of the offense. Brown in motion. They give it to Fred Russell. Russell stopped up at the 23-yard line. Russell came into the season a Joe Walker candidate, one of the top running backs in the country. Had a tough week last week against Purdue, playing against one of his former high school teammates, Nico Kudavides, at middle linebacker.
And Mark, he has the potential to have a fifth year because of a medical situation he had. But he's decided, told us yesterday, he's coming out in the NFL draft. He's 23 years old. He's loved his experience in it here at Iowa. But it's time to move on.
Second down and 8. Chandler for Ochoa. And good coverage that time by Tremaine Banks, the freshman on the corner. With stride for stride with Ochoa.
And they love the ability of Trumaine Banks, this freshman corner. That time locked on man-to-man, but field position marked the essence of football. Iowa started out on the 19-yard line. First possession of the second half field goal. Started out on the 25-yard line here with the second possession.
Third down and eight.
And you notice Cervantes in at fullback in the one-back set. High, high tendency of Iowa throwing the football.
Chandler to Ochoa out of the backfield, and he's wrapped up immediately at the 21-yard line. Cervantes makes the catch on the play.
Textbook hit, Bob. Excellent open field tackle right here. It makes it a little bit easier that it's the fullback out here and not Jamel Lewis, but Justin Fraley, who did not play last week against Wisconsin, has been a linebacker, has been a safety. They use him a lot in nickel situations. Another good stop by Minnesota's defense right here, forcing another field goal attempt by Mr. Automatic. 3 for 3 today.
This one coming from 38 yards out. And he knocks it through. Nate Kaeding, a history major, carrying a 3.48 GPA. Minnesota, if history serves itself well, is in trouble. They've lost the last two. Abdul Khalid got to get it cranked up when we come back.
Leon, your reaction following today's devastating loss?
Football is a team sport, man. So I got to put the loss squarely on the shoulders of my supporting cast. Look, man, I've been carrying these guys the whole season, but I can't do it all. I need some help.
So your four fumbles weren't a factor in your mind?
Not if one of those other guys would have jumped on the ball. Again, Leon can't do everything.
There's no I in team.
There ain't no we either.
Today's word is obvious.
Obvious?
Yes, obvious. Like dialing 1-800-COLLECT to make a collect call.
Collect calls, 1-800-COLLECT. That is obvious.
So is that fake laugh. 1-800-COLLECT. Duh.
For decades, Quattro all-wheel drive has revolutionized racing. Now our advantage is yours in every model line. The Advantage Audi event. Take the advantage now. For exceptional values on exceptional cars, go to AudiUSA.com.
Men don't like to shave. They'd rather light their shorts on fire or eat dirt. Easy, fellas. Nivea soothes the pain of shaving. With moisturizers and vitamins, Nivea for Men Aftershave Bomb soothes and improves. Nivea for Men, more evolved skincare.
ESPN College Football Saturday. Brought to you by 1-800-COLLECT, the obvious choice. And by Budweiser. Grab a cold, fresh Budweiser. It's game time.
Welcome back, everyone, to Iowa City. Hawkeyes right now shocking the Gophers, 26-6. The fifth best offense in the country with just 6 points on the board so far. The result of numerous turnovers. Kaeding with the kickoff. White fields it almost at the three. Back to the two. Made it out to the eight. Reese, the Hawkeyes are scoring. Back to you.
And so too is Lee Evans. Not that we doubted it, but he is officially back. 8 catches, 231 yards, and 4 touchdowns on the day, including this beauty. Evans is now 70 yards and 1 touchdown away from the Big Ten single game record. He's got a lot of time to go. We'll keep an eye on it for you. Penn State and Indiana. Nittany Lions up by 24-7. Andrew Gilman with recovery of the block punt. And Penn State has a 31-7 lead. He's going to get their first Big Ten victory, it would appear.
Yeah, we've been subsequently quite a lot of those Joe Must Go critics, at least for a week. First down and 10. Maroney over the left side of that offensive line behind Setterham and Melander. Minnesota, the number 5 ranked offense in the country, number 1 ranked rush offense in the country. Today, a little bit below those numbers. Bob, when you're behind by this much as a running team, what happens to the game plan?
Well, Mark, you hit the nail on the head. Two things jump out at you right there. 6 points. They have 273 yards with 9 minutes left in the third quarter. It's a lot of yardage. field position has really hurt them here, obviously, in the second half.
Maroney again. Tried to cut it up inside. Stopped up at the 15. They're going to give him about the 16-yard line. It'll be third down and about three to go.
Glenn Mason trying to make a statement here of staying in the game plan. As you mentioned, they are a running team, so they're going to continue to run it. This is a critical third down, Mark, because, as we mentioned, field position is such a factor in this game. They love the three-step quick slant to the big, tall wide receiver.
Oshak and Ellison will come to the short side of the field. They get the first down. Aaron Hosak was ruled down at the 22-yard line, tackled by Antoine Allen. It'll be a first down, Minnesota. And Hosak a little shaken up.
Hosak marked the 6'5 junior college transfer from wide receiver. They did come back with the slant, excellent throw and a catch, first down. Hosak, you mentioned earlier, a great catch against Wisconsin last week on third and nine with a minute left. Here's the three-step drop, the slant. Good call. Hosak was down. The ball came out late. Good call once again by the officials.
That right knee right there twisted underneath him when he was brought down by Antoine Allen. He's favoring that right leg. Four catches today for 52 yards. A transfer from Mount San Antonio Junior College. Top wide receiver on the team, yardage-wise. Thomas Tepe now, the lone back behind Assad Abdul-Khalik. First down and 10 for the Gophers. Tepe, the strongest member of that Gopher team, unable to get much yardage, maybe got two. He bench presses 430 pounds, squats 630 pounds. A graduate student originally from Liberia, one of those seniors for Minnesota. Might have one of the best bodies in all of college football.
And Mark, you're right. He does have a great body. He was a high school Minnesota High School Player of the Year. This guy has NFL potential because he can do so many different things.
Talked about the blocking game in football 101. That's one of his strengths. Second and nine. Abdul-Khalik was lucky to get away from the sack brought down by Hodges. For more on Thomas Tepe, let's go to Holly.
Guys, you talk about the commitment these players make. How about the commitment their family makes? Thomas DePay's sister, Vicky, went out and bought hair, hand-dyed it, and put in these Minnesota Golden Gopher blade extensions, I guess you'd call them. Maroon and gold. And she says, I've had to live with these things all season. I think it may be hurting her social life, but she's going to stick it out. Finish to the end of the season, guys.
You got to do a lot of things with hair when it comes to football. My son, Clay, he got a mohawk because his team's going into the state semifinals this week. So that hair is kind of synonymous with late season football, I guess, Mark.
Hey, unity. Yeah, you got to show it. Got to have it. Tony Patterson making the grab about a yard shy of the first down. And there's a look at the Kay sister, family from Liberia.
I don't know, Bob.
How do you think I'd look in blonde extensions?
Mark, I think you look good in anything you wear.
Let's go downstairs to Holly Rowe. Holly, fourth down and one. We're going to get to Holly in just a bit, but it's fourth down and one right now. A critical situation for the Gophers. Asana Abdul-Khalik.
Mark, you mentioned critical. I'm a little surprised that Thomas Tepe is coming out of this football game, and that if they are going to go for it, they're probably going to quarterback sneak. But a little surprised there's not a lead blocker in the game.
Abdul-Khalik kept it himself. Not sure that he got there. This is going to be extremely close. He's a mobile quarterback, a good runner.
And Glenn Mason knows that the football game hinges on this. I don't think he made it, Mark. It was fourth and almost a yard. I don't think he made it.
The Iowa defense agreeing with you. Going to bring in the chains and measure still. You know that offensive line, we see them pull and do a lot of things in the running game, but are they a finesse line? Are they a power line?
Mark, I think the reason Glenn Mason ran the quarterback sneak, Iowa, with those injuries inside at the defensive tackle position, but it ended up to me. He made it. But getting back to my point, a lot of people don't like the quarterback sneak. I'm not a big fan of it, quite honestly. Maybe if it's Nathan Chandler, 6'7", but Iowa with some injuries up front. Jerry Krause back in the game, but it's all irrelevant because it's first and 10.
And Aaron Hosak back in the ballgame as well for Minnesota offensively, lining up to the top of your screen. They go in a two-back set for one of the few times today. It's Maroney. Tackled near the line of scrimmage at the 32. Reese, tell us about the SEC a little bit.
Well, he showed you what happened to Florida on the last play of the first half. The punt return for a touchdown by South Carolina. And now the Gators on a drive. Third and three. Boy, how good is this freshman, Chris Lee? Knows the five bend. Proof is tied in for a touchdown. And the Gators are within two. And Miami's kicked a field goal. They're tied with Syracuse in the fourth quarter. We'll watch both of them for you.
Miami playing this week. With all the different little distractions, it's Miami versus Miami. And I respect Syracuse, but it's all about the change.
On the quick slant, complete near the 40-yard line, Aaron Hosek making the grab about 3 yards short of the first down.
And Mark, it may not happen here, but it's only a matter of time until you get the slant and goal from Minnesota. Once again, the three-step drop, they throw the slant. You see the corner right here driving on the football, Antoine Allen. Slant and goal is set up right now for Minnesota.
Ellison, Patterson, and Hosak, the wide receivers. On third and four.
Picked off by Johnson.
And another Minnesota turnover. The fourth of the ball game.
Mark, they only had 11 in 11 games coming into this football game. To have four turnovers in the 12th football game of the year, you have no chance. Norm Parker,
the veteran of so many Big Ten seasons, he used to be in Minnesota, right now turning the tables on his former fellows. We'll be back.
Your day was something new.
I wake up to cold feet.
It's guys in the know.
It's a real baseball White House.
And the better you feel, the more sex you tend to have.
Oh, my goodness.
Girls with the down low.
When you roll suited up as a jockey.
This is a rocket with wheels.
It's the dog.
That's dangerous.
And the hawk.
I just want to be
a little mayhem.
Oh, my God.
In the AM.
Are you hot wings or are you cold pizza?
You don't get this at any other morning show.
Wake up to cold pizza. The morning show with everything. Weekday mornings at 7 on ESPN2.
Since 1917, Bank Iowa has been serving the Oskaloosa and Mahaska community as the premier provider of financial products and services. At Bank Iowa, we're proud of our long history of customer service and our commitment to the community. We make it a point to get to know the people who use our services at Bank Iowa. We believe it's important that our customers bank at a place where people work hard every day to earn their trust. Bank Iowa, committed to community, customer service, and you.
All over Southeast Iowa, you'll find homeowners choosing First Choice Realtors as their first choice for selling and buying their home. Their years of experience and dedication makes your home buying and selling experience a success. Each agent knows how to listen to what you need. They're ready to help describe the real estate process in a simple, easy-to-understand manner. When you're ready to buy or sell your home, call the professionals at First Choice Realtors. Your best choice is First Choice.
Iowa leading 26-6 with 4:12 to go in the third quarter. The turnover number often tells you so much about how well a team does. Look at the difference in today.
Field position and turnover. Iowa coming into this game 96 in the country and forcing turnovers with only 15, but four forced already today, Mark.
First down and 10. Mo Brown with his first catch of the day. The senior out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida, tackled at the 33-yard line. Mo Brown, I had a chance to spend some time with him yesterday, Bob, but asked him about his most indelible moment at Iowa. Interestingly enough, he told me that
it was last week's game, coming back from injury. Had a lot of question marks in his head about whether he'd be able to go, and it gave him a lot of confidence to be able to perform, get three balls.
Yeah, Mark, and I'll tell you why. To come back from injury, missed five games. He had that ice on the ankle yesterday. You realize how many treatments he's gone through to just get healthy here late in the season.
There's Lewis. Jamel. Feeling it. Lewis. Steps out of bounds at the five-yard line.
And another guy getting healthy right here in front of our eyes. We mentioned Jamel Lewis coming back off the ACL injury. Iowa again with the zone. Just everybody blocking an area. Jamel Lewis cuts back and then breaks out of there. Eli Ward chasing.
Made that Superman dive for the end zone. Just out of bounds.
Right there. Good call. He obviously stepped out of bounds.
First down and goal from the five for Iowa. In control, 26-6. Lewis tackled at the line of scrimmage by West. And tell us about Lee Evans, Reese Davis.
He tied a Big Ten record with his fifth touchdown catch of the day against Michigan State. Spartans have given up more touchdown passes than any team in the Big Ten. There's been Georgie finding Lee Evans, who is still within striking distance. He's 301 yards receiving to match the Big Ten single-game receiving record. 42-14 in that one. Penn State's rolling as well.
Talk about players coming back off injuries. Mo Brown, Jamel Lewis. How about Lee Evans?
Greatest comeback story of the year in college football. Second down and goal to go. Chandler. Touchdown, Otoa.
Mark, that was a great catch by Otoa. The ball thrown behind him against the blitz. Senior day in Iowa City.
Razor Otoa out of Maywood, California.
You're going to see this ball thrown behind him right there. Tough to defend that one.
Fifth touchdown reception of the season for a young man who filled in very well for Mo Brown, a guy they were counting on a lot during the early part of the season. He really carried offensively this team from a receiver standpoint early in the year. 33-6 for Iowa. Two great matchups in primetime on ESPN and ESPN2 tonight at 7 Eastern on ESPN2. Larry Fitzgerald and number 16 Fitz take on West Virginia. And at 7:45 on ESPN, number 3 LSU, and a must-win for them in the hunt for the Sugar Bowl, the Nokia Sugar Bowl. They go to Alabama to take on the Crimson Tide. There's a look at their remaining schedule at Alabama, then tough one on the road at Mississippi, finishing up at home, and then that SEC championship game, man. Those things are always unpredictable. I'm not a big proponent of conference championship games, Bob.
Well, Mark, on one hand, it gives you an opportunity. If you're a number 3 BCS team like LSU, you know you're going to play a quality opponent, so it gives you a chance to move up the polls. But on the flip side, from a coach's perspective, I don't know that I like it either. That's a tough, tough matchup.
Guys beat each other up all year and then got to do it again in the title game. Kaeding to kick off. A very poignant Saturday afternoon for 24 seniors who are playing the final home game for the Hawkeyes. Maroney on the return, and they rocked his world at the 14. Edmund Miles with the tackle on the play.
And right now, what's going through Glenn Mason's mind, he knows he's going to go play in a bowl game. But that bowl game, Mark, probably won't be till late December, or what Glenn's hoping for, early January. Today's November 15th, so he lives with the outcome of this game for over 6 weeks.
And we saw what happened actually last year when Iowa had that long break in between their last game on the sixth group against Minnesota until they played in the Orange Bowl down in Miami. Russ definitely a factor in that game, among other things. Didn't quite turn out well for them. Maroney brought down by Abdul Hodge, and Minnesota's offense reaching to a halt in this ballgame. The fifth leading offense in the nation. Look at that.
And Mark, we look at this two fumble situation.
That was what was critical, and then the interception on the last series. So not only have they not moved the ball, they've not punted it and created field position. They've turned the ball over. This has been a game of field position.
Second down and 10. Incomplete over the middle, intended for space, and let's go to Reese Davis.
Okay, Mark, the second down, the Hurricanes tied at 10 against Syracuse about halfway through the fourth quarter. The young running back, Tyrone Moss running through tackles and putting Miami on top. Still a lot of time to go, but the Canes finally in the lead, 17-10.
Miami not beating themselves on that play. Third down and 10. 6-15 on third down. Ross with a little pressure. Complete to Hosak for the first down at the 41-yard line. As you see, Hosak come back from that injury a few moments ago. A pickup of 27 yards.
Excellent job by Asad Abdul-Khalika stepping up in the pocket. We have Hosak right here against quarters coverage. The ball's thrown inside on the corner.
Yeah, Jovan Johnson.
Jovan Johnson, that was a big completion. Mark, they've got to go play action and get the ball down the field. I think you're on first and 10.
Jay and Maroney, the backs behind Asad Abdul-Khalika. Looking for Ellerson. What a catch! It went through the arms of Bob Sanders, who seemed to have a beat on it. But Jared Ellerson made a huge catch for another first down for the Gophers. They have got to get busy. 1:25 to go in the third.
Right here you see Ellerson on the corner route. Bob Sanders, wow, broke on that football. You have to wonder how that football went through his arm. Bob Sanders, though, Mark, had an excellent day today.
First down and 10. Abdul-Khalik takes off, makes it down to the 37-yard line where he's tackled. And tomorrow morning, don't miss the best NFL pregame show in the entire business. NFL Countdown presented by Old Spice. Chris Berman and the gang previewing all of Sunday's action. It begins tomorrow at 11 a.m. Eastern on ESPN.
And I know you're disappointed that the Playmaker series is done for the
what
year.
Because
I know you're a big fan of Playmaker.
It was nice to see Leon have a say in the final success of that team, even though Lucas Harris killed him in the end.
Did it break your heart when Arizona, I think, won and didn't go to the playoffs?
Unbelievable. Second and 5. Here's Maroney again. Maroney stopped up at the 40-yard line. There's 20 seconds to go in the third quarter. Iowa Hawkeyes have won 11 consecutive games here at Kinnick Stadium. This place has become a graveyard, a terror dome for visiting teams. Minnesota can attest to that this afternoon. And here's sellout crowd of over 70,000 here, rising in an ocean of black and yellow. At the end of the third, let's go downstairs to Holly Rose. She'll tell us what's coming up.
Hey guys, you won't believe what was happening in the parking lot here in the tailgating area for the Iowa Hawkeyes. The first time I've seen it, a couple of stuff to say with I Do. We'll tell you about it coming up.
Monday Night Countdown, delivered by UPS, 7:30 Eastern on ESPN.
For decades, Quattro all-wheel drive has revolutionized racing. Now our advantage is yours in every model line. The Advantage Audi event. Take the advantage now. For exceptional values on exceptional cars, go to AudiUSA.com.
Why do we work? Why do we get up every day and go to work? Because we make things, fix things. Send our kids off to learn things. At the Principal Financial Group, we know you don't just work to retire, you work to live. That's why we give people the financial tools to help them keep more of the money they make and do more with the money they save. You work hard, we make work hard for you. The Principal Financial Group. We understand what you're working for.
Let's see what we got today. Where's the jersey? There's the jersey. You've been outbid. I've been outbid.
Yeah.
That's it.
switching to Earthlink.
Speed up your internet with new Earthlink Accelerator. Web pages load up to 5 times faster than regular dial-up, and you don't need new hardware. Call 1-800-EARTHLINK and get 6 months of dial-up service featuring Earthlink Accelerator at half price. Move to Earthlink. It revolves around you.
Over 1 million understand its strength. It can improve your energy, your shape. This is Bowflex Power Rod technology, and it can only be found on genuine Bowflex equipment, like the new Bowflex Extreme. Now you can get the results you want, the exercises you need, all at an affordable price. You've never seen this Bowflex before. Pick up the phone and call the number on your screen now to get a free video or DVD and check out the new Bowflex Extreme. You can have a high-performance body. Just look for real Bowflex Power Rod technology, proven effective at burning fat and building muscle. Now you can own the new Extreme for no money down and only $19 a month. The Bowflex Extreme is not available in stores. You know you're ready. Let Bowflex help you get there. Call now for a free video or DVD today, because your results matter.
Back in Iowa City, Kinnick Stadium. Sold out today for the last home game of the season, and right now Iowa leading 33-6 as we begin the fourth quarter. And Ramon Ochoa has had a huge day for the Hawkeyes, one of 24 seniors playing his final game at home, and inside that box, Floyd of Rosedale.
He's not in there, Mark. That's a decoy.
On third down, Asad Abdul-Khalik fires incomplete. They'll have to go for it, Bob, on fourth. That's a foregone conclusion. You know, interesting rivalry between these two teams when you talk about Floyd of Rosedale. I guess back in the day in the 40s and 50s, the Iowa-Minnesota thing was almost like Michigan-Ohio State back in the day.
And, huge rivalry game. I mean, border state. And a lot of the people from Iowa either go to Chicago or Minnesota. You're either a Bears fan or you're a Minnesota Vikings fan. Probably a Vikings fan this year, the way the Bears are playing.
Fourth and seven. Complete. It's right at the first down marker, kept by Hostak. And if they're spotting it where they're due, it's going to be close. Now they're going to say it's incomplete.
Mark will get a chance to look at it again. Again, the three-step slant to Hostak on fourth down.
Thought he had that ball, Bob.
Marky flipped over right there. We didn't have a great angle.
I'd say he had the ball, he hit the ground, and it came out. In which case it would be a completion, had one official come in from the far side appear to signal completion, but it's coming back the other way. First down and 10. Fred Russell with a gaping hole. Out near midfield, brought down by Ward. Let's go to Reese in the studio.
Well, Mark, it apparently is blowout Saturday in the Big Ten. Penn State going to get its first conference win. Joe Paterno going to snap that 6-game losing streak. Michael Robinson to Tony Johnson, wide open against the Hoosier defense. That's his third touchdown catch of the day. Nittany Lions have hung half a hundred on the Hoosiers, 52-7. Virginia Tech has just scored. Jones over 100, it's 10-0.
At midfield, it's first down and 10 for Nathan Chandler. Pulling the trigger for Brown. Flag down, and Brown makes the catch. Mo Brown in traffic. Gotta wait and see who this flag is against. There appear to be a little contact down the sideline.
Pass interference on the defense. That penalty be declined. Result of the play. First down.
Mark, when you're hot, you're hot. You're gonna see Mo Brown locked once again on Yuki Dozier. Little stutter and go. Yuki Dozier right here in pretty good position. Never turns back and plays the football. But that's a great catch right there by Mo Brown. Unbelievable catch. Caught it off of Yuki Dozier's helmet.
Right off his dome. Here's Jermell Lewis into the boundary. Going to be brought down to the 21-yard line. Now, Kirk Ferentz, like I said, has orchestrated one of the great turnarounds in all of college football over the last 5 years. His first year, they went 1-10. Followed by 3-9, Bob, and
it's at the point now where, you know, we're walking on the pedestrian mall and people are saying, oh, it's a down year. We're not that good this year. They're 7-3. The expectations are so high now.
Well, Mark, we were a big part of last year's magical season. It was a magical season. But you're right. Fans do get spoiled quickly. And as Kirk told us, this hasn't been a routine season by any stretch of the imagination. He's got a lot of injuries.
Got a great coaching job. Chandler on the bootleg up for Ochoa, but it's out of bounds, incomplete. It'll be third down for Iowa.
But Kirk Ferentz, Mark, yesterday made a good point. You know, when you have high expectations, as Iowa's team, coaches, and fans have, when you lose like you lost last week at Purdue, you have to readjust those goals. And they're going to keep it simple. They just want to win their last two games. Today here at home in Kinnick, next week up at Wisconsin, and then figure out what bowl games they're playing for. But readjusting those goals, particularly when you had high expectations, is a big part of coaching, giving them something to play for every week.
And they move to 8-3 with a win here today against the Gophers. Chandler on the loose. Chandler, the big fella, lowering his hat and putting it on the Gophers. First down, goal to go. A 15-yard gain by Nathan Chandler.
Mark, that's a big dude running with that football right there.
Carrying it kind of loose, too.
He's a good athlete. Played at South Lake Carroll, Texas, right outside of Fort Worth. Had an excellent high school career.
From the 7-yard line. Fred Russell. Tackled at the 4. Been a tough day of sledding for Fred Russell. Last year in this game against Minnesota, rushed 17 times for 194 yards. And was very adamant before this game about telling anyone within earshot, teammates, media members included, we will run the ball today against Minnesota. Second and goal. Chandler. Broke a tackle. Stopped short of the end zone just inside the 1-yard line. And he took a heavy hit from Ben West, among others.
Eli Ward, Minnesota's number one tackler, and as physical a safety as there is in college football, he usually knows to come on the blitz and run by the quarterback. Right here, bam! He didn't wrap the arms, and at 255 pounds, you better wrap those arms.
Ben West.
A pretty good pop in there at the end, too, by Ben West.
Lee Chandler's head ringing a little bit. Here we go, third and goal. Cervantes. Touchdown.
Senior day, Ramon Ochoa's high school teammate, Cervantes, gets a chance to score a touchdown in his last game at Kinnick Stadium. Mark, how about two guys coming from East L.A.? That is a long, long way.
A world away. Yep, a world away, Bob. But today, Iowa has been the picture of efficiency in the red zone, in stark contrast to Minnesota, who in the first half coughed it up twice in the red zone. And that kind of set the tone for what was to follow. Well, the only question that still begs, who's inside that box? Got a little bacon for you. A little pork. We'll be right back.
Maybe holiday hotline. Looking for a hot hoodie? Here's the 411. Whether we're down in the snow or on the street, we got every kind of street, man. It's so unique.
Living is cold outside, so it's still all good. Little Kimbo keeps it hot in the old Navy hood.
All the hotties
bought
hoodies just
1950. You're in the hood now, baby.
There's a state where there's fun around every corner, where all cars are turbocharged, and there's a direct link between the right foot and a smile. Maybe that's why people who test drive a Saab usually buy one. This is the state of independence. Welcome.
The turbo. turbocharged Saab 9.3 linear sports sedan. Available in the state of Independence for as low as $299 a month.
Who are the best playmakers?
No, John Lynch.
I like Roy Williams.
I'm going to say Michael Vick.
Maybe Ray Lewis.
Tony Gonzalez.
Who are the best playmakers?
Oh, you asking me?
Sean Johnson.
Love him.
Clinton Boyd.
Thank you,
Jimmy.
But who's the best playmaker?
Me.
Me.
Myself.
Yours truly.
Number 34.
You're looking at him, baby.
Who are the best playmakers? Get online with Madden NFL 2004 and decide for yourself. Only on PlayStation 2. Rated E for everyone. EA Sports. In the game.
I'm gonna wrap myself in paper. I'm gonna dot myself with glue. Stick some stamps on the top of my head. I'm gonna mail myself to you. Oh, I'm gonna tie me in a little red string. I'm gonna tie blue ribbon too. Climb up into my mailbox and I'm gonna mail myself.
This holiday season, no one will work harder or go farther to keep us all connected.
They've been competing for Floyd of Rosedale since 1935. It started with a bet between the governors of Iowa and Minnesota. The winner of the game would wrest Floyd away from the other and would stay with the winners for a year. And the locals, Bob, say that Floyd is well fed now on some corn and grain and some other stuff, a swap we can't mention.
Mark, he isn't going anywhere, so he's going to be back in Iowa for another year.
Sure looks like it. It's 40-6. This is Maroney on the return. Let's take a look at our gateway game track. The Iowa seniors today have really shone. Like Quasar shooting across the Iowa skies. Big plays by all the seniors, and Nate Kaeding including with a 55-yard field goal. Turnover is one of the big stories for Minnesota. And the Hawkeyes have been very opportunistic, capitalizing on most of those. First down and 10 for Asad Abdul-Khalik in Minnesota. Dragged down from behind at the 23 by Howard Hodges. And Reese, tell us about the Oklahoma Sooners.
Well, they're taking off already against Baylor, marching right down the field. Jason White, Heisman Trophy candidate, finding Brandon Jones, 25 yards out. Number one team in the land with a quick 7-0 lead. Bob Stoops still has the starters in the game.
Is that a reference to, like, maybe running up the score or something, Bob?
I noticed a little cynicism right there in Reese's voice. Unlike him, but, yeah, I'd like to be Baylor right now, sitting there staring at Oklahoma coming at you.
That's no joke. First down and 10 for Minnesota. Ball at the 32.
Now it becomes Howard Hodges and Matt Ross time.
The team off, yeah. I thought Abdul-Khalik collared that time by Abdul Hodge, one of those other guys just pinning his ears back and coming on defense.
You know, we gave a lot of kudos to Minnesota's offense, but what about Iowa's defense? You know, they took it personal last week that Purdue was to run for 154 yards on them. They have the 11th best defense in the country, the 5th best rushing defense, 8th best scoring defense. This is a proud Iowa defense. You know, Mark, last week against Purdue, they had no sacks in the game for the first time in, I think, 29 games.
Wow. Abdul-Khalik completes the pass for the first down out at the 45-yard line. And getting back to the point about Iowa last week against Purdue, and it happens, Bob. The parents said that we just didn't have the tempo and pace and overall juice that we usually go into a game for. Let's go downstairs to Holly.
Well, guys, right here as we see Minnesota running the ball with Thomas DePay. Kirk Barrett told his team, Mark, I'll send it back up to you to finish this play.
Okay, Holly, it's DePay down to the 22-yard line. Nice run by the Gophers and a first down. Let's go back to you, Holly.
Kirk Barrett put finds up in the locker room this week that said the enemy is not on the opposite sideline. It is us. And what he was meaning by that was their performance last week against Purdue. Not only did they not have sacks and underachieve on defense, but they had uncharacteristic penalties on offense. He said, we left several touchdowns out there on the field. Their goal this week was to perfect what they had done wrong last week.
Did a great job of it so far. Abdul-Khalik completes it to Ellison at the 17-yard line. Right now they are in hurry-up mode, but they might be a little too late.
And when, Mark, is the slant and go going to come from Minnesota? They've thrown 10 slants in this game.
Second down and 3. DePay
Running it to the short side of the field, brought down at the 16-yard line by Chad Greenway. 9:45 to go. You know what? At practice on Thursday, I had a chance to listen to a very impassioned speech by Kirk Ferentz addressing his team, talking about the lack of effort in the previous game. He said, hey, we have to take equity in this team. We have to self-police ourselves. A pass incomplete, meanwhile, to Tony Patterson. And you've got the feeling that the Hawkeyes got his message loud and clear. He talked for some 15 minutes about guys getting to class, guys handling their business, just basically doing what they're supposed to do. And they brought the noise today on the field where it counts.
Mark, it's a long, long season. You start in August and you go all the way through January. A lot of twists and turns, a lot of ups and downs. But if you do things right, on and off the field, you normally end up successful.
Fourth down and three for the Gophers.
Bob Sanders again coming on the safety blitz.
They're going to whistle this one dead.
Prior to the snap. Ball start. Offense. 5 yard penalty from the previous spot. So fourth down.
Push this one back a little bit to the 22 after the penalty. We fourth down and eight to go.
And we've got Glenn Mason over there, the conference coach of the year mark in three different conferences, which is really an unbelievable feat by a football coach. And interestingly, from New Jersey, Assad Abdul-Khalid grew up about 2 miles from Glenn Mason. So these guys got a pretty good bond going after 5 years of Khalid being in that program.
Got a lot invested in each other. Fumbles. The hit by Ross. And it's going to be Iowa ball. First down and 10 the other way. They're going to mark it at the 23. The fifth turnover of the day by Glenn Mason's Minnesota Gophers. And we got a timeout down in the field. And remember we saw two people who are about to say, I do or I don't? Maybe we'll find out in a minute.
Are you primed for week 11? That's what we're here for. Countdown's got the Parcells and Belichick reunion covered. We'll talk to the Tuna and preview the showdown between the division leaders, Cowboys and Patriots. Sunday NFL Countdown, 11 a.m. on ESPN.
Home is where the hoop is. With ESPN Full Court, you'll get more than 450 additional games of college basketball. To order, call your local cable company, DirecTV, or Dish Network.
Are we ready for some football?
Coach, we're ready for some ice and then gay.
These are my demands. I want a great breakfast every morning and an evening snack and an internet station. And I want one of those Serta pillow top beds. Those are my conditions. I want them every day at every Heartland Inn, and I want them at no extra charge.
We can do that.
What?
Oh. Get what you want at Heartland Inn. Call us or log on to heartlandinn.com.
Aren't you the best for a new car?
9:24 to go in the fourth quarter. The Iowa Hawkeyes, ranked number 20, leading the 17th ranked Minnesota Gophers by a score of 40-6. I'm Mark Jones, along with Bob Davey and Holly Rowe. Special Saturday for a special couple. Come to a football game, makes you want to do a lot of different things. The pass complete to Cervantes at the 24, and for more on that, let's go downstairs to Holly.
I've been covering football for a long time, and I've never seen a wedding in the parking lot in the tailgate area. Today, Deb Smith and Pete Welch decided to tie the knot. They got on their first or second date last year here, and Deb says that's when she fell in love with Pete, so they decided, hey, why not? Pete surprised her this week. They have been engaged, but Wednesday he told her, we're going to do it in the parking lot where we fell in love, and they did it this morning at 10 o'clock. Congratulations, the Welches.
Holly, where are they going on that honeymoon?
Actually, he said they're going to postpone their honeymoon for about another month because he is in active duty in the military, and he is a retired naval captain, so they haven't planned the honeymoon yet.
Well, maybe they can hit one of Iowa's bowl games. If they keep going well like this, might not be a bad idea. Get down to a warm weather spot and enjoy a bowl game for your honeymoon. I mean, I can't think of a better way to celebrate my nuptials if I was to do it like that. But who am I to say? I mean, I proposed to my wife at a basketball game at halftime, so. Third down and 9. But that's not important right now. We've seen Marcus Schnorr on that last carry, an opportunity to carry the football for Iowa. Chandler still under the snap. Ocho, who's having a brilliant day at the 31-yard line. Let's go to Reese Davis. Miami still beating themselves.
No, in fact, they're making a play, Mark, at the end. 4th and 8, R.J. Anderson. Hey, look, they're on the 20-yard line of the game, trying to tie this thing up, send it to overtime. Throwing for Johnny Moran, and most sides is there to knock it away. And the Hurricanes escape 17-10. Florida and South Carolina. Mighty Gators have come out in control of the second half thus far. Deshaun Wynn going through the Gamecocks defense. 24-16, Gators up.
Comeback there by Zook's crew. 4th down and 2, the Hawkeyes going to punt. David Bradley standing on his own 17. What a 70-yard punt earlier in this game. This one not quite as long, comes down to the 33-yard line. This one goes 37 yards, and a timeout down in the field, and senior day always filled with pointed and poignant moments, especially for this guy, Nate Kaeding. We'll be back with more on that after this.
There's a place where the air is fresh, the wind is cool, and the curves are exciting, where all convertibles are turbocharged, and the sun has a very hard time keeping up.
Yeah, you know, you can only get that DVD here. Get you front and center for the Rolling Stones show.
Get Four Flicks, the ultimate live Rolling Stones concert DVD box set, exclusively at Best Buy. Thousands of possibilities. Get yours.
Shoot you right down. All the
little Olympus brings you the incredible power of a 10x optical zoom. Get 10 times closer. Now that's a powerful zoom.
Zoom, 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 zoom.
The Ultra Zoom from Olympus. Designed to do more.
Zoom, 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 zoom.
ESPN College Football Saturday, brought to you by Saab. Welcome to the State of Independence. And by Best Buy, thousands of possibilities. Get yours.
We are back in Iowa City, Kinnick Stadium. The Hawkeyes leading 40-6, 7:45 to go. I'm Mark Jones, along with Bob Davey and Holly Rowe, and you can almost hear the celebrations beginning down in the pedestrian mall in South Dubuque at Brothers and at the field house. Getting ready to get the celebration going. Abdul Khalik complete near midfield. The Tim Patterson, a 16 senior, makes his first catch of the day. And they are in hurry-up mode. Still, Park, Minnesota, now with about 430 yards offense, but only 6 points and, more importantly, 4 turnovers. Flag down on the play. Iowa had too many men on the field. A great catch at the 31-yard line by Jared Ellerson. But, like I said, there's a flag. Penalty going
going against Iowa. And a couple of great matchups in primetime on ESPN and ESPN2 tonight. At 7 o'clock on ESPN2, Pittsburgh Panthers taking on West Virginia and Quincy Wilson. Get a look at Larry Fitzgerald, maybe the best player in the country. And then at 7:45 on ESPN, LSU takes on Alabama. Michigan Northwestern also dueling battle at 3:30 Eastern time. First down and 5. Pass complete at the 37-yard line. This time it's Aaron Hostrath making the grab. He is working on Marcus Pascal. Minnesota will fall to 9-3 and miss their first 10-win season since 1905. Iowa looking at improving to 8-3 overall. It's not Abdul-Khalik firing incomplete, and let's go back to Reese in the studio.
Well, Mark, you know, only one man caught more touchdown passes than Mark Slate of Oklahoma this year, and that's Larry Fitzgerald of Pittsburgh. Sooners against Baylor, Jason White up top again. This will be touchdown catch number 13 for Clayton, and it was indeed a pretty one. 14-0, Duke's Poop on top of him.
You just kind of take for granted how good Oklahoma is.
They're cut above.
Unbelievable.
Second and 10. Abdul-Khalik completed the 32-yard line. Mark, Matt Spade, the backup tight end.
And we must mention Ben Utak, Minnesota's starting tight end, not playing. He's had some reoccurring problem with an abdominal pull. They really like Matt Spade, this young tight end. His dad played college football at Nebraska. That was 30 points a game in basketball in high school.
Well, you hear the ovation as the pass is completed, 26-yard line. That ovation you heard, the cheers you heard a few moments ago, were for number 33 for Iowa, Bob Sanders, the starting strong safety who came out of the game on that last sequence. Sanders, one of 24 seniors, playing his last home game, and he chronicled his incredible journey. He was part of the team that really helped turn this program around. Back in 2000, they had a win on the road at Penn State. He made several huge plays, had several big hits, and has since become a cornerstone here at Iowa. Abdul-Khalik, a flag down.
We're going to get holding, Mark, and this one's going to come back. If you talk about Bob Sanders, what makes him so valuable is he is a physical football player, and he's a great special teams player. That's contagious amongst your players, particularly your younger players. So when you got a guy that's a hitter and also a special teams guy, that makes a big, big statement to the other players on the team.
And Holly Rowe, he had 16 tackles today, Holly.
Well, you guys, it's amazing that he's even in a Hawkeye uniform. Nobody recruited him out of high school in Pennsylvania, but Kirk Ferentz is old high school coach that coached him. But hey, this is a kid worth taking a chance on. Kirk Ferentz said, if you can't trust your old coach, who can you trust? He gave the kid a scholarship, and Bob Sanders came here and just completely changed the whole way that they play defense. He said their intensity from his beginning year when he started out on special teams until now is a complete mojo over. His defensive attitude, they say how he plays, says everything. He's so quiet on the sidelines, he rarely ever says anything or gets the guys fired up. He does it all on the field the way he plays.
A real picture of the way it should be in college football, Bob Sanders.
Mark, it's amazing as you watch this game. Minnesota's offense just continues to unravel. And you think back early in this game, the missed opportunities they had, and then don't forget the Nate Kaeding 55-yard field goal at the beginning of the half. Minnesota comes out the second half, turns the football over right away, and all of a sudden it just goes south on you. There is not that much difference between these two football teams, but because of momentum and mistakes and turnovers, this thing is just snowballed.
Minnesota, 449 yards of total offense. If you look at the box score in your morning paper tomorrow, you think, what happened in this ballgame? First down and Altoona to go. Hostak complete down to the 24-yard line where he's tackled. 6:05 to go. Got Abdul-Khalik, a senior from Minnesota, playing in his last regular season game. The next time they suit up, it'll be a bowl game. Interesting, a devout Muslim. He is honoring the season of Ramadan right now. I'll tell you more after this play. Abdul-Khalik set back to pass. Complete down to the 17-yard line to Statham. Back to Abdul-Khalik during Ramadan.
Muslims do not eat during the daylight hours, so right now he has to wake up early, have a small meal. I know last year we were talking about a bowl of cereal or two, and that has to hold him until the sun goes down.
Amazing, Mark, and his second all-time total offense at Minnesota.
Third down and short, Maroney. Brought down just inside the 15. Looks like he's going to have the first down. Asad Abdul-Khalik rewriting the Minnesota record book. Statistically, a pretty good day, Bob.
And coming off an injury, did not play the second half against Wisconsin. Did not practice that much this week. But, Mark, he's been in this system so long, he's like having an offensive coordinator out there on the field.
Pass complete to Ellison. Stopped up short of the goal line at the two. And Glenn Mason says about Asad Abdul-Khalik, he says, you can't fool dogs and kids. They can inherently and innately smell out good things and good people. And Mason talks about whenever Abdul-Khalik comes over to his home, his kids are always playing and love playing and dancing with him and doing all kinds of crazy fun things. First down and goal, the 10th play of the Minnesota drive. Tepe broke a couple of tackles and got into the end zone.
That's a big man right there, Mark. Thomas Tepe.
That's his 7th rushing touchdown this season. Hey, and his sister Vicky loves it. Party on, Vicky.
You're not worried about that score, Mark. That's her brother out there that just got in the end zone.
His 20th career touchdown, a guy that is pretty high on some NFL lists, Bob.
No question, Mark. A blocker as a fullback, good pass receiver, and kind of a tailback when he gets his hands on the football. Minnesota going for two right here, obviously.
Lining up out of the eye, Maroney the deep back, Patterson in motion. Abdul-Khalik wide open. And they get the two-point conversion to match base. Well, they got the deuce, but the pig's going to be hanging out in Iowa City for another year. Oink, oink, and we'll be right back.
There's a state where there's fun around every corner, where all cars are turbocharged, and there's a direct link between the right foot and a smile. Maybe that's why people who test drive us off usually buy. This is the state of independence. Welcome.
The turbocharged Saab 9.3 linear sports sedan, available in the state of independence for as low as $299 a month.
January 1961, we weren't sure who we elected. In November 1963, we couldn't assess what we lost. On Sunday, we'll discover what we gained. JFK, a presidency revealed on the History Channel.
Men don't like to shave. They'd rather light their shorts on fire or eat dirt. Easy, fellas. Nivea soothes the pain of shaving. With moisturizers and vitamins, Nivea for Men Aftershave Balm soothes and improves. Nivea for Men, more evolved skincare.
They're saying running back by committee is bad for football. I was just saying I see the relevance of committees, just not for running backs. Wait, if I was thinking that, then they were thinking that.
Minnesota with 14 points in the ball game. That is the 5th leading offense in the nation. They usually score 40 points a game. And don't put it by the Gophers to come up with an onside kick. That's the way they started their game, a game that we broadcast, Bob, back against Penn State a couple of months ago. But Mason not averse to pulling a rabbit or two out of his hat. Although at this point, it's pretty much a foregone conclusion. With 4:52 to go. This is senior day, 24 Iowa seniors playing their final home game here at Kinnick Stadium. Snore brought down at the 26-yard line, and this was the scene earlier today. About 15 minutes prior to kickoff, the seniors being introduced along with their families respectively. Bob Sanders, before that it was Gallery, Fred Russell and his crew, some prominent seniors including Nate Kaeding, and a very heartfelt, poignant moment, welling up.
That's a great shot, Mark. And I'll tell you, who ought to be crying is Kirk Ferentz, because Nate Kaeding graduates.
I might too if I was his head coach. And for more, let's go back to Reese in the studio.
Guys, we've got a finish brewing in Columbia. Florida up 8 on South Carolina. Fourth quarter, Donrell Pinkins breaking tackles and stretching into the end zone now. Gamecocks down 2, went for 2, did not convert. So the Gators clinging to that 2-point edge.
And back here, Reese, one of those 24 seniors shaken up on that last play. That's the starting right tackle, Sam Aiello. 6'5", 305-pound senior. This senior class is going to go out on a high note here in their last home game of the season. Fred Russell started out the game with an electric kickoff return. Some 47 yards. And Robert Gallery doing a great job making pancakes on that offensive line. And Ramon Ochoa from Nathan Chandler, a couple seniors teaming up. And Bob Sanders on defense, one of the hardest hitters in the league. And Nate Kaeding, who you saw welling up a few moments ago with a career-long 55-yard field goal. And our Olympic players of the game, they're going to share the love today. Giving it to all 24 seniors. It has made an indelible imprint on this Iowa program. Took a lot of courage for them to come in and sign on the heels of a 3-9 season back in 1999. And down to the 31-yard line. Let's go downstairs for more on the seniors from Holly Row.
I'm here with Nate Kaeding's parents and mom, Terry. What was it like, Meg, to hear the crowd give your son the biggest ovation of any player as he walked out onto the field?
Well, it was quite a thrill, and I guess we didn't really notice the ovation because it was a pretty emotional moment for all of us. But we're real proud of him, and more proud of the fact of the teams and the coaches that he's been associated with here at Iowa.
This is his dad, Larry. And Larry, this boy has won state championship after state championship, a Big Ten championship. Where did you get that competitive spirit from?
Oh, a little bit of luck, I think, but got a lot of coaches and some good role models along the way, so he's had a great time of it. We're proud of him.
What were your thoughts when he kicked a 55-yard field goal to go into the half?
About time. Finally got it done.
And how did you like his celebration? He was still out on the field getting people celebrating.
Oh, he's still a young kid. He has a lot of exuberance.
And what's it been like for you as parents to watch him grow?
Great. Watch him mature the way he has. It's kind of what every parent hopes for.
All right. Well, thanks very much. Larry and Terry Kaeding.
All right. Thanks a lot, Holly. And you look at how proficient he was today and on the year. 11 of 12 coming into the ballgame. Now 15 of 16 on the season. All that, and he's not even at full health right now. On fourth down and 6, Bradley the punt, standing at his own 16-yard line. They run this clock down. Low snap, fielded well by Bradley. A high spiral comes down to the 33. A 37-yard punt, nothing on the return. Let's take a look at our Old Navy sideline. Minnesota just 14 points today, courtesy of those 5 turnovers, and Iowa with 37 unanswered points to put this one away. This one is cooked, glazed, and ready to be sliced.
Marking for people that haven't been to Iowa City, these are some of the best fans in all of college football. They took 47,000 people down to the Orange Bowl last year, and I'm talking about Iowa. They have great fans here.
Asad Abdul-Khalid on the move, and ducks down at the 37-yard line. Yeah, Fred Russell, one of those 24 seniors that we've alluded to during the course of this show, asked him about his most memorable moment, feeling moment here at Iowa, and Fred said it was when we were on the bus going to the game at Pro Players Stadium in Miami for the Orange Bowl against USC last year. He said he looked outside, peering through the tinted windows at the fans, and right then and there it hit him that they had arrived when he saw to some 40,000 fans outside and inside the stadium, that they had arrived as a program and he had arrived as an individual. Abdul Khalik completes the pass to Tony Patterson at the 38-yard line. So for both these teams, well, Minnesota anyway, they will wait around and try and wait by the phone, see who's going to call which bowl game they'll be headed to with 9 wins on the season against 3 losses. Iowa, meanwhile, with a, you could say, a key game next week at Madison against the Badgers.
Mark, and I'll tell you what, you have to love Asad Abdul Khalik right now playing this football game out. His last regular season game, a fifth-year senior who was hurt last week with a shoulder, couldn't even play. 545 yards total offense for Minnesota in this game. They're only averaging 495, but the turnovers, Mark, killed them.
They're good. Up to Pay running it down to the 12-yard line with 146 to go. Look back on Minnesota and really set the tone for their success this season, looking at their bowl game last year.
I got to ask you.
Go ahead, Bob.
I want you out on the limb.
Hit me.
You like Ohio State or Purdue?
I'm going to take the Boilermakers, having seen them last week and having seen Ohio State a couple weeks before that.
You like Ohio State or Michigan the next week in Ann Arbor?
I just think Preble's got them. I think Ohio State has a way of beating Michigan the last couple of years. Pass incomplete in the end zone. And what about you? Who do you like in that Ohio State-Purdue game? Remember the big play by the quarterback in Jenkins last year for the touchdown?
I'll say this. I think Purdue is probably the more balanced of the two teams, offense, defense, kicking. But Ohio State is great defense, Mark, and they're survivors.
I just
like Ohio State.
Yeah.
I know you didn't want to let me answer that.
Go ahead.
I like Ohio State.
I just think Purdue learned a lot from their loss on the road at Michigan. I can't see them coming up as quiet as they did in that game. Having said that, starts at 3:30, right? Into the end zone and incomplete. Knocked away out of the arms of Hosak at the last minute. And you know, in all of this destruction from Minnesota's perspective, Abdul Khalik has passed for a career high 388 yards.
But Mark, not a great signal because, as we know, Minnesota came in here the number one rushing offense in the country. And when you turn it over, you fall behind and you're not able to run the football.
Third and goal, they're going to run it this time. Thomas Pate got in, touchdown.
Where's his sister?
Show me those rocks.
There it is.
It's your birthday.
I'll tell you
it's
what.
It's your birthday. Go ahead. Take what your mama gave you. Go ahead. She hasn't looked at the scoreboard, but that's not important right now.
Oh, man.
That's her big brother doing his thing.
Tell you what, she's just calling the Hawkeye fans out.
Hey, you got your brother as your bodyguard. You can say anything you want to. Go for the two-point conversion. The fade pattern. Complete to Hosak. Go ahead. Work that thing. Work it. We'll be right back.
Where can you find 77 years of service?
At Fairfield Lumber Company in Fairfield, Iowa. We offer top-quality products at competitive prices from manufacturers like Anderson Windows and Doors, Pratt & Lambert Paint, Wolverine Vinyl Siding, and Merillac Cabinetry. We also provide superior customer service before, during, and after the sale. The right prices and products with the best service since 1926.
Fairfield Lumber Company, one block north of Highway 34 on 3rd Street in Fairfield.
Helping people achieve success is Tenco Industries' goal. Tenco Industries in Ottumwa now has a can redemption center. Our convenient hours and fast, friendly service make can redemption easy. Bring your cans and bottles to Tenco Industries, 710 Gateway Drive in Ottumwa. Tenco
Industries, people achieve success. 40 to 22, but that score very flattering for Minnesota. Really not that close. Iowa Hawkeyes play their last home game of the regular season. Next week, they are in Madison to take on the Badgers. Tomorrow morning, Sunday NFL Countdown presented by Old Spice at 11 a.m. Eastern Time, 8 a.m. Pacific Time. Chris Berman and the crew breaking it down for you. And don't forget, coming up next, on the College Game Day scoreboard presented by Acura, Reese Davis, Trev Alberts, and Mark May in the studio. Recapping a busy Saturday afternoon in college football. First down and 10 for the Hawkeyes. Backup quarterback in the ballgame now for Iowa. That's the freshman, Drew Tate. Watch him throw in practice on Thursday. He has got a rifle, a cannon of an arm.
You're high on him.
I like him.
I thought you were going to start a quarterback controversy when I saw you Thursday night about how much you like Drew Tate.
I had to let him take a couple snaps before I got that stirred up.
Yeah.
One of the most productive high school passers in Texas football history.
And ended up at Iowa because R.C. Slocum was fired at Texas A&M, was going to go to Texas A&M, but Floyd is out.
Big for everybody.
I'll tell you what, the way this game has gone, Minnesota would have dropped Floyd as many times as they put that pigskin on the ground today, Mark. You got a point there, Bob Davis. A.J. Johnson.
So the Iowa Hawkeyes will have their third consecutive victory over the Minnesota Gophers in this series, competing for Floyd of Rosedale, and the goalposts are quietly being lowered. The final score, 40-22, Iowa moving to 8-3 overall on the season. It's been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. College Game Day scoreboard presented by Acura is next. So long, everybody.
Glad to have you with us. From College Game Day scoreboard presented by Acura. I'm Reese Davis alongside my partners, Trev Alberts and Martin May. We're going to take you out for more Big Ten action just after the bottom of the hour. Michigan and Northwestern from Evanston as Michigan tries to avoid that stumble before Ohio State comes into the Big House next week. And we just saw Minnesota and Iowa, the Hawkeyes getting their 40-point game and 40-22 victory. Iowa now 8-3. They'll finish up on the road at Wisconsin coming up next.